大家早上好。
Good morning, everyone.
好，无论你是在出爱中心现场，或者是在新达城的朋友，还是在线上的朋友们，欢迎来到我们的双语聚会。
Well, whether you are over here at Touch Center, over there at Suntec, or joining us online, welcome to our bilingual service.
哦，如果你们知道的话呢，在这个周末呢，在新达城呢有这个旅游展哈。
Well, I'm not sure if you know that right now in Suntec there is a travel fair going on, and it really caused us a huge jam yesterday.
对，昨天我们去到新达城，哦，找不到这个停车场。
Yes, we couldn't find a parking lot. 啊，
就是这个旅游展让我想起呢一个想要问你们一个问题。
And this whole travel fair got me thinking about a question, and today we want to ask you that question.
在我们在现场的还有在新达城的朋友，你们有谁呢曾经呢去过一个旅游？然后呢，你爬山呢，去看一个非常壮丽的景色，有吗？
How many of you here? One of your trips? Can you have ever gone on a travel and you actually climb up a mountain in order to look at a magnificent view? Okay, so how many of you love scenery? You have done that before? Lift up your hands.
嘿，举起手，哇，非常多人哈。但是我相信呢，如果你有这样的经历的话。
Right, we have the experience.
你也一定知道，在这个爬山的过程呢，是非常的累。
You know that climbing a mountain is very tiring, isn't it? 这，
但是呢，你一旦呢到这个山顶上
哈。But once you reach the top of the mountain, 哇，
哇，所有的辛苦啊都是值得。
All the effort that you put into climb the mountain is worth it.
因为呢，你会从新的这个高度呢看到令人惊叹的这个景色。
Because from that height, you will just have a new perspective and a breathtaking scenery.
现在呢，我要大家想象一下哈。
So right now, I want all of us to imagine.
从这个诗篇第一百二十一章第一到第二节。
From Psalms 121, verse 1 to 2, the psalmist says,
我要向山举目。
I lift my eyes up to the mountain.
我的帮助从何来？
Where does my help come from?
我的帮助从造天地的耶和华而来。
My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
这个诗人就像我们一样。
So know this psalmist is just like us.
他仰望这些高耸的山啊。
When he looks at all the mountains.
但他真正做到的是，他把他的注意力呢，从问题呢转向于神。
And no looking at the mountains causes him to actually shift from his problems to fix his eyes on the Lord.
我相信呢，我们大家呢，在我们生命里，我们都有属于我们自己的一座山。
Well, I believe in our lives, all of us we have different kind of mountains.
这个山是我们生命中的一些问题，还有一些障碍、一些挑战。
This could be personal problems, challenges that we are facing.
当你盯着这些问题的时候，它会越来越大。
And when you look at all these problems, it will just look bigger.
但这个诗人呢，给我们一个非常重要的关键。
But I know the psalmist gives us a very good suggestion.
我们不要专注于山。
To not fix our eyes on the mountain.
而是仰望那创造天地的神。
But to fix our eyes on the maker of the heaven and earth.
因为神是我们帮助的来源。
Because God is the source of our help.
好不好？我要邀请大家一起站起来，好吗？
So can I just invite all of us to stand right now?
Okay, 我要做一个非常有趣的一个练习。
We are going to do And we are going to go through an experience.
好不好？大家一起闭上眼睛。
Can I get all of us to close our eyes? 啊，
闭上眼睛哈，深呼吸一下。
Take a deep breath.
然后呢，想象你站在山顶上。
Right now, imagine you are on the top of the mountain.
然后有一些山风。
Okay, you can feel a breeze.
然后呢，你想象你从山顶上呢看下去。
And as you look down,
你会觉得呢，一切都变得。渺小。
Everything looks smaller.
当你站在山顶的时候呢，你从新的角度看世界。
And as you are on the top of the mountain, the world just looks so different.
今天神要给你一个全新的视觉。
Today, the Lord wants to give you a new perspective.
当我们仰望他的时候，
No, as you look to him,
一切都会开始改变。
Everything begins to change.
好不好？我们数到三声。
No, at the count of three,
我们把一切的赞美都献给我们上帝。
We just want to lift up our praise to the Lord.
我们要宣告。
We want to declare.
他是创造天地的神。
That He is the maker of heaven and earth.
他会永远准备的帮助我们。
And He will always be there to help us.
当我们进入敬拜的时候。
No, when we enter into a time of praise and worship.
我们会宣告。
We will declare.
我们有移山的信心。
That we have that faith to move mountains.
因为主会帮助我们。
Because God is our help.
一。
One,
二,
two,
三,
three.
来，我们欢迎主。
Can we just praise the Lord?
Hallelujah, 主，我们欢迎你。
Hallelujah, Lord, we praise you, Lord. Woo! 是的，主，我们赞美你，配得所有的赞美。Hallelujah. 我们宣告，将天敞开，你的荣耀将。
敞开你的荣耀降下来，将天敞开，你的同在降下来，将天敞开，你的荣耀降下来，将天敞开。 King forever. Almighty God, we lift you higher. You are the only King forever, forevermore. You are victorious. You are the only King forever. Almighty God, we lift you higher. You are the only King forever, forevermore. You are victorious.
Lately, I've been praying for a few things, but don't seem to see any breakthroughs. But God keeps reminding me to press on and to look to Him, because He is our shield, our strength. He's our hope. Amen. If you're in a similar situation, continue to trust God. Hallelujah. Thank you.
很多时候，可能我们祷告的时候，但是我们没有看到突破。 但是今天神提醒我们，我们要定睛仰望神，因为我们的神是我们的盾牌，我们的神是我们的力量，我们的神是我们的盼望。Amen。好不好？今天我们敞开我们的心，我们再次的跟神说：神啊，我们需要你，帮助我们定睛仰望你。Thank you, Jesus.
Christ alone took on death, fully God, fully man. This gift of love and righteousness scorned by ones, He came to save. No fear in death, no fear in life. I have my hope in Christ alone. No fear in death, no fear in life. I have my hope in Christ alone. Christ alone took my place, and for freedom's sake, He made that way. A gift of love I could not pay. No fear in death,
是的，主，我们感谢你，你是不撇下我们的神，你是爱我们的天父。 Lord, we thank you that you're a God who never leaves us nor forsakes us, and you're a God who loves us.
Oh, 神伟大的爱，何其长阔高深，经不离弃他独生爱子，为我们众人舍了生，成唯一的人，谁能控告，谁能定他们的罪。谁能抵挡我们？谁能使我与神的爱隔绝？难道是患难吗？是困苦吗？是逼迫吗？是饥饿吗？是赤身裸体危险刀剑吗？无论是高处的，是低处的，现在的事，将来的事，都不能将我与神的爱隔绝。
Let's just take this time right now to receive the Lord's love afresh for us, because indeed nothing can separate us from His love. Lord, we thank you for this. We thank you for sending your Son Jesus to die on the cross for us so that we can have hope. Thank you, Lord. So that we can be set free. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. 主啊，我们感谢你。
这是何等荣美的名，这是何等荣美的名。
Lord, your name is beautiful.
没有人能够像你。
No one compares to you.
唯有你的名能够让我们被拯救。
Only through your name can we be saved.
唯有你的名能够带给我们盼望还有平安。
And it is your name that can bring us hope and peace.
主，我们宣告。
God, we declare.
你是掌权的主。
That you are in control.
主，我们宣告。
God, we declare.
你会在我们的生命中做一个大大的一个工作。
That you will do a great and mighty work in our lives.
我们要把我们的生命呢，重新的交托在你手
中。And today we surrender our life once again afresh to you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
主，我们感恩你在我们当中。
We thank you, Lord, for your presence.
Amen.好吧，我们继续的带着这个敬拜的这个心态进入这个祷告的一个时间。
Right now, let's just enter into a time of prayer.
好吧，我们现在思考，再次的思考诗篇第121章第1到第2节。
Let's just reflect on Psalms 121 verse 1 to 2.
因为神的话语呢带给我们力量。
Because the word of God gives us strength.
神的话语呢会激发我们。
And the word of God will just give us the motivation that we need.
神的力量会赐给我们信心。
And the word of God will give us that confidence.
我要向山举目，我的帮助从何来？
I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from?
我的帮助从造天地的耶和华。
My help comes from the maker of the heaven and the earth.
好不好？我现在邀请大家闭上我们的眼睛。
Can we just close our eyes right now?
现在呢，我要你想象呢，在你的面前是 一大巨山。
And before you, I just want you to imagine a huge mountain.
就好像我刚才所说的，我们生命里，我们每个人都有不同的山。
As what I've said earlier on, in our lives, there may be different mountains.
无论是什么问题呢，或者是挑战。
Whatever problems or challenges.
我们现在呢，主要赐给你一个移山的信心。
Right now, the Lord wants to give you a faith that can move mountains.
好不好？我们数到三声的时候。
And at the count of three,
我们来宣告。
We are just going to declare.
在我们生命的这些巨山会被移走。
These mountains will move in Jesus' name.
在我们生命里的一些问题和挑战会有突破。
These problems and challenges that we are facing, we will see the breakthrough.
一、
one、two、three.
好不好？我们凭信心来祷告。
Let's just declare.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Lord, our help.
神会赐给你力量。
Comes from you.The maker of the heaven and the earth. God, you are help. Today we lift our eyes up to you. We lift our eyes up to the mountain. Not at the problems. Lord, we fix our eyes on you. All these mountains will move in the name of Jesus. Because your word says that faith is small as a mustard seed can move mountains. Lord, we declare the mountains
will disappear.
Disappear, be gone right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
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 Let me declare.
To the name of the Lord
is greater than every circumstance that we are facing. Hallelujah.
Let's
lift up our hands.
Hallelujah. 天父，我们向你举目。
Heavenly Father, we just fix our eyes on you.
主，我们知道我们的帮助是从你而来。
Because we know that our help comes from you.
你是天地的创造者。
You created the heavens and the earth.
没有什么是你做不到的。
Nothing is impossible for you.
主，我们把我们生命里的重担。
Lord, we just cast all our burdens,
我们生命里的问题和挑战
all the problems, all the challenges,
都摆在你脚前
we just place it at the foot of the cross.
主，我们信靠你的大能
God, we trust in your power.
我们信靠你的力量
we trust in your strength.
我们信靠你完美的时间
we trust in your timing.
主，赐给我们移山的信心
Lord, give us a faith that can move mountains.
主，让我们继续的信靠你
so that, Lord, we can trust in you.
赐给我们力量
give us strength.
主，我们感谢你聆听我们的祷告。
Lord, we thank you that you are listening and hearing our prayers.
这一切是奉主耶稣大有能力的名祷告。
In the name of Jesus, Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. 我们鼓掌给主。
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Lord,
好不好？在你坐下之前。
And before you sit down,
跟你身边的人说
tell the person beside you,
诶，这座山没有了，
诶， the mountain has disappeared.
不见了。很好啊，这是凭信心的宣告。
Yes, and we are declaring all this
生命里的祭山没有了。
That our mountains in our life is gone in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen, amen. 好，现在呢，我相信我们大家，我们都知道，现在我们要进入一个非常重要的一个时刻。
And right now we are entering into another important part of our worship service.
不是爬山哈。
We are not going to climb mountains.
我们是奉献的时间。
It's our offering time.
好不好？让我们预备好奉献的心呢，一起来奉献。
So let's prepare our hearts to give to the Lord.
奉献呢有两个方式。
There are two ways that we can give.
第一是线上奉献，然后还有我们这个现场的实体奉献。
We can give online.Or we can give on site.
你可以上网呢，上这个链接呢，进行线上奉献。
You can log on to this link that is shown on the screen right now to give.
这个链接呢会保持开放24小时。
And this link will be kept open 24 hours through the week.
所以你可以在来临的一周呢的任何时刻呢，到这个链接进行线上奉献。
So you can give any time in the week.
如果你现在要给奉献的话呢
And if you want to give right now,
我要温馨提醒大家呢
Just a gentle reminder
我们这个红色格子的二维码呢是我们立场的十一奉献
The red box is for regular tithes and offerings
这右边蓝色 格子的二维码呢是我们宣教信心任线
And on the right, the blue box is for our missions faith pledges
宣教信心任线是立场和十一奉献以外的奉献
And the missions faith pledge is over and above our general offering
总体来说呢是用于资助各种不同的项目呢，借此将福音传遍万国。
And it's used for a variety of initiatives that furthers the gospel's reach to the nations.
还有呢，要再提醒大家，奉献箱呢，这个也是同样的，有红色和蓝色的这个部分。
And similarly, if you are giving on site, there are boxes that are located around the auditorium that has some blue and red indications on it.
好吧，我们现在闭上眼睛，一起把这奉献呢交托给主。
So let us pray.
亲爱的天父
，Dear Heavenly Father,
我们。再次宣告我们的帮助是从你而来
Once again we declare that our help comes from you
我们感谢你在我们生命中的供应
We thank God for your provision in our lives
我们承认呢我们生命的一切呢都是来自于你
We declare, we know and acknowledge that all that we have it comes from you
我们宣告这些奉献呢会被你大大的使用
And we trust and declare that all that we are giving right now will be used greatly
会来扩张你的国度
For the furtherance of your kingdom
我们也相信呢你也会继续的信靠你你会继续在我们生命的各方面呢继续的供应我们
And we continue to trust in you that you will provide for us in every area of our lives
这一切是奉主耶稣基督的名求
We pray this in the mighty name of Jesus
Amen
Amen,
Amen. 好现在我们有做一些简单的一些报告
We have a few announcements today
第一个报告非常重要今年的最后一场组长会议呢将于11月12日星期二不是星期三啊11月12日是星期二晚上7点45分在出海中心大堂进行宝亮牧师呢将会在会议中分享我们在教会在今年年底和2025年的精彩活动及动向
Well, first announcement, cell leaders meeting our last cell leaders meeting of the year will be held on Tuesday the 12th of November 7:45 p.m. at Touch Center Auditorium so it's a Tuesday alright take note of that
对,
so join us this meeting to hear from Pastor Daniel on the exciting things that are coming up for us at the end of the year and also into 2025
温馨提醒大家呢我们会将在下个周末呢11月2和3日的聚会中呢守圣餐如果你参加线上的聚会呢请在聚会开始前事先准备好圣餐的材料
And a quick reminder that we'll be partaking the Holy Communion next weekend on the 2nd and 3rd of November If you're joining us online, do prepare your elements in advance
好下个月呢我们教会将举行许多精彩的活动这个荧幕上的这个显示了教会在11月份的活动你也可以上教会的网站呢或到 WhatsApp 和 Instagram 频道查看这个日历哈，哇，很精彩，很精彩，真的，
很 colorful 啊 ，very colorful，
很精彩。
So there's a lot of activities that are happening in church next month in November. So you have a glance at our November calendar of events up right now on the screen, and this calendar it is also made available on our website, WhatsApp, and Instagram channels.
好了，报告就完毕了。
Yes, that's all that we have this weekend.
好，你们兴奋吗
？Are you excited?
你们要移走这两座山哈。
We need to move these two mountains.
所以你们要大大的鼓掌。
So you must clap very loudly.
可以听神的话语。
To listen to the word of God.
好吧，我们现在欢迎我们的主任牧师邝宝亮。
Let's welcome Pastor Daniel.
还有达川来。
And 达川 to bring the interpretation.
Hallelujah.
Hi, good morning, everyone.
大家早上好。
Good to see those of us here at TC and those of you at Suntec as well.
很高兴在这里和在新大学看到大家。
Happy to be back bringing the word of God.
很高兴重新回来正道。
Last week couldn't be here as I was over at Suntec with the Encounter Weekend.
上周不能正道是因为我在教导经历神会在新达城。
And today I have something I suppose very important I wanted to share with all of us.
那今天有一件很重要的信息要和大家分享。
But before I get into that, maybe let me just frame for us what we've been going through over the last 2 months.
那分享之前，我们先讲一下我们过去两个月所讲的一些信息。
Our messages over the last 2 months has really revolved around this whole idea of community.
三个月前两个月的信息都是围绕着群体来讲的。
And that's important because the church is about people. It's a community. It's a family.
因为这很重要，因为教会就是一个群体，就是一个家庭，一个子民。
And so about 2 months back, I started off with a message called Gather Together.
大约两个月前，我们开始的信息叫一同相聚。
And I reminded us of the importance of the church gathering physically together.
我提醒大家，教会是要实体的一起聚集在一起。
After that, I brought a message called Get Real, where I talked about authenticity.
然后之后的一篇信息叫活出真我，讲到的是真实性的重要。
Then there was a message called Order in God's House.
然后还有神家中的秩序。
And I was teaching about submission.
教导的是关于顺服。
And how submission is a key aspect of functioning as a community.
讲到顺服是在社区里面很重要的一个因素。
Then over the Children's Day weekend.
然后儿童节聚会的时候。
I preached in Chinese that weekend a message called A Strong Family.
那时候我用华语正道讲的是一个坚固的家庭。
And share what makes us stronger.
讲到什么使我们能够坚固。
Then the week after that, we heard some updates on what we're doing through Touch Community Services.
然后那一周之后就是我们听到关于出外社会服务的一些事工。
And I brought a message called Don't Forget.
我讲的信息的主题是不可忘记。
And I said we must not forget that It's in our church's DNA to bless society, to serve the community.
我说我们不可忘记，这是我们教会的基因，是要服侍社群。
Now, last week then, Pastor Roland brought us a message called God's Community in Difficult Times.
然后上一周有人牧师带来的信息是艰难时期的属神群体。
And he taught us that for us to be a strong family during difficult times.
他教导说，就要在艰难时期成为坚固的家庭。
We must be, number one, diligent in shepherding.
我们必须要第一要殷勤牧养。
Number two, humble in submission.
第二要谦卑顺服。
Three, steadfast in suffering.
第三要坚忍苦难。
So today I'm going to bring us the word of God.
所以今天我要讲的信息。
But this word is not really a continuation of Pastor Roland's message.
但这不是永恩牧师的延续。
It's really a continuation of the last message I preached.
而是我上一篇道不可忘记的延续。
And if I could, I would have preached this message last week, but like I said, I was at the Encounter Weekend.
如果可以的话，我本应该是上一周讲这篇信息的。
Now, I'm not saying that Pastor Roland's message was not important, it was a great message.
但不是说有牧师的信息不好，也是非常重要。
But this message today is really a continuation of that weekend when we talked about Touch Community Services.
而是这篇信息是讲到出外社会服务那篇信息的一个延续。
Now, during that message, I made this statement.
在那篇信息我讲到这样一句话。
A strong family must also be committed to a vision and mission.
一个坚固的家庭必须也要委身于一个意向和使命。
And here's the reason why.
这里是原因。
A church must not only function well internally, but also effectively express our faith outwardly.
教会不仅要在内部运作良好，也要向外有效地表达我们的信仰。
So to be an effective spiritual family,
要成为一个有效的属灵的家庭。
On one hand, we must know how to function together, be a strong, united family.
一边我们要知道如何成为一个坚固合一的家庭。
But we must also be committed to a purpose, a mission that brings our faith outside of the church.
但是我们要委身我们的信心在我们的教会之外。
So with that, the message for this weekend is called The Purpose-Driven Church.
所以这周这信息的主题是使命教会。
And that's really what our church needs to be.
这是我们教会应该要成为的样子。
While there may be many things to do in life,
虽然生活中有很多的事情要做，
we must never forget the purpose that God has given to us.
但是我们绝不能够忘记神给我们的旨意。
Now today's message will be in two parts.
今天的信息会有两部分。
The first part will really very much be a sermon.
就是第一部分就是正道。
And the second part, well, it's going to be some updates I'm going to give us about our church.
然后第二部分是关于我们教会一些进展。
Or as one leader put it last night,
就是昨天晚上一个领袖说的
this leader said that it's really about talking about family matters.
就是讲到是家里面的问题。
不是问题了，家事。
家事对家事。
不是问题，是好东西，不是问题。Okay. But with that, let's jump into today's scripture.
那我们看一下今天的经文。
If we want to be a purpose-driven church,
如果我们想要成一个使命的教会，
well, let's look to a purpose-driven church in the Bible.
我们就看一下圣经里面讲到使命教会的经文。
A good example of such a purpose-driven church, I would say, is the Antioch church.
一个最好的例子当然就是安提阿教会。
You can read about it in the Acts chapter 11 and 13.
我们可以看《使徒行传》十一章还有十三章。
I'm not going to bring us through every single verse, but I'll lead us through so that we know enough about this church.
但我们不会看每一章每一节经文，但是我们会看一些重点的关键的经文。
So the Antioch Church, Acts 11 and 13.
就是安提阿教会《使徒行传》十一还有十三章。
A few things to take note of this.
我们需要注意的是。
Firstly, this church was birthed out of persecution.
首先，这个教会是在逼迫中诞生的。
And it was a church very much started.By lay people,
是由一般的信徒开始的。
Meaning, it wasn't like missionaries sent somewhere to plant a church.
不是被宣派的宣教士去那边执坛。
It was a group of Christians there who came together and they formed the church.
而是一群基督徒聚在一起成为一个教会。
Let's look at Acts 11:19-20.
我们看一下《使徒行传》十一章十九到二十节。
Now, those who had been scattered by the persecution that broke out when Stephen was killed traveled as far as Phoenicia, Cyprus, and Antioch, spreading the word only among Jews. Some of them, however, men from Cyprus and Cyrene went to Antioch and began to speak to the Greeks as well, telling them the good news about the Lord Jesus.
那些因斯提凡的事遭患难而四处分散的门徒，只走到腓尼基、塞浦路斯和安提阿。他们不向别人讲道，只向犹太人讲。但内中有塞浦路斯和古利奈人，他们到了安提阿，也向希腊人传讲主耶稣的福音。
Now, as this church and community started to form in Antioch, they began to experience revival.
但这个群体在安提阿聚集在一起的时候，他们经历了复兴。
And we see that revival in Acts 11:21.
我们在《使徒行传》十一章二十一节看到这里。
Where it says, the Lord's hand was with them, and a great number of people believed and turned to the Lord.
讲到主的手与他们同在，信而归主的人数很多。
Not just people turn to the Lord, a great number turn to the Lord.
不单是人信主，而是信主的人数很多。
And as they began to experience this revival,
他们在经历复兴的时候，
they started to receive guidance and direction from the church in Jerusalem.
他们就领受来自耶路撒冷教会的指引。
And the people of Antioch, these Christians, they were the first ever to be called Christians.
而在安提阿的信徒也是首先被称为基督徒的。
Verses 22 to 26 says this.
是22到26节这么说。
News of what was going on reached the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch. When he arrived and saw that the grace of God had done, he was glad and encouraged them all to remain true to the Lord with all their hearts. He was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and faith, and a great number of people were brought to the Lord. Then Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul, or also known as Apostle Paul. And when he found him, he brought him to Antioch. So for a whole year, Barnabas and Saul met with the church and taught great numbers of people. The disciples were called Christians first at Antioch.
22节，这风声传到耶路撒冷教会的人耳中，他们就打发巴拿巴到安提阿去。他们到了那里，看见神所赐的恩，就欢喜，劝勉众人要立定心志，恒久靠主。这巴拿巴原是个好人，蛮有圣灵和信心，于是有许多人归服了主。他又往大树去找扫罗，就是使徒保罗，找着了，就带他到安提阿去。他们足有一年，和教会一同聚集，教导了许多人。门徒称为基督徒是从安提阿开始的。
So here you see them experiencing God for themselves.
所以他们自己经历了神。
But beyond that, they would express their faith outwardly as well.
但是他们也要向外展示他们的信心。
Because they would then begin to give their money or their resources for other work of the church outside their own city.
因为他们开始为他们城市之外的事工捐款。
So look at verses 27 to 30.
我们看27到30节。
During this time, there were some prophets who came down from Jerusalem to Antioch. And one of them, named Agabus, stood up and through the Spirit of God predicted that a severe famine would spread over the entire Roman world. The disciples, as each one was able, decided to provide help for the brothers and sisters living in Judea. This they did, sending their gift to the elders through Barnabas and Saul.
但那些日子，有几位先知从耶路撒冷下到安提阿。内中有一位名叫亚加布， 站起来，接着圣灵指示普天下将有大饥荒，这是在克劳地年间果然实现了。于是门徒决定照个人的力量捐钱送去供给住在犹太的弟兄，他们就这样做了，托巴拿巴和扫罗的手送到众长老那里。
So beyond that, they will also then start to send out missionaries.
此外他们也差派宣教士。
And that's what we see in Acts 13 verses 1 to 3.
这是在13章1到3节里面看到。
Now in the church at Antioch, there were prophets and teachers, Barnabas, Simeon called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, and Saul. While they were worshipping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them. So after they had fasted and prayed, they placed their hands on them and sent them off.
在安提阿的教会中有几位先知和教师，就是巴拿巴和被和称为 尼杰的西面、古利奈人路球与叙利分封王一起长大的马念和扫罗。他们在侍奉主和进食的时候，圣灵说要为我分派巴拿巴和扫罗去做我照他们做的工作。于是他们进食祷告后，给巴拿巴和扫罗按手，然后派遣他们走了。
And after Barnabas and Paul were sent out, they began to impact the entire region.
巴拿巴和扫罗被差派出去以后，他们就开始影响整个地区。
And Acts 13:4 onwards is really where they began Paul's first missionary journey.
使徒行传十三章第四节讲的是使徒保罗的第一个宣教之旅。
Now the church of Antioch is really very spiritually significant.
所以安提阿教会在属灵里面是很重要的。
I mean the fact that the first Christians were called Christians there shows some level of significance.
那时候信徒第一次被称为基督徒，所以很重要。
But I believe it was significant because they were a purpose-driven church and people.
但是我们相信它很重要，也是因为他们是使命的教会。
And so today we want to look at them and learn what are some of these key characteristics of a purpose-driven church.
所以今天我们要看这个教会从他们当中学习使命教会是怎样的。
So today there are three things I want to be sharing with us.
今天要分享三点。
Three things that the purpose-driven church must be.
三点就是使命教会必须要有的。
So let's start. Number one.
第一。
The purpose-driven church must firstly be spirit-led.
使命教会必须是圣灵引导。
Now, what does it mean to be spirit-led?
圣灵引导是什么意思呢?
It is to depend on and yield to the Holy Spirit's power and leadership.
是依靠和顺服圣灵的大能和领导。
Now, let's look at Antioch, this church.
我们看一下安提阿这间教会。
The first thing we see was how God's power was among them.
第一件事我们看到的是神大能在他们当中。
In Acts 11:21, it says, the Lord's hand was with them and a great number of people believed and turned to the Lord.
使徒行传十一章二十一节这么说，主的手与他们同在，进而归主的人数很多。
Other translation says that the Lord's power was with them.
其他的译本讲的是神的大能与他们同在。
Because God's hand is always synonymous with His power.
因为神的手和他的大能是近义词，是可以互用的。
So for example, Isaiah 48 verse 13.
比如说以赛亚书四十八章十三节。
God Himself says, "My own hand laid the foundations of the earth, and my right hand spread out the heavens. When I summon them, they all stand up together."
神他自己说，他说我亲手立了地的根基，以右手铺张诸天。我一召唤天地就都立定。
The hand of God represents His authority and His power.
神的手象征的是他的权柄，他的能力。
And the reason Antioch was experiencing revival was because the power of God was on them.
所以安提阿教会经历复兴，是因为神的大能与他们同在。
And people there must have been constantly encountering the reality of God's power.
他们可能是常常在经历神的大能。
I believe that the sick were constantly being healed.
我知道很多的病患得到医治。
Miracles were taking place.
很多神迹发生。
God's glory, His presence and His power was there.
神的同在，神的荣耀正在他们当中。
And I guarantee you that something very incredible was taking place there.
我可以保证有很不可思议的事情在那里发生。
How do we know that?
我们怎么知道呢?
From this very fact in verse 26.
从二十六节这里讲到的。
The disciples were called Christians first at Antioch.
门徒称为基督徒是从安提阿开始的。
Now why were they first called Christians here?
为什么是这里开始称他们为基督徒呢?
Were they the first ever Christians?
他们是不是第一批信徒呢?
No, they were not.
不是的。
But they were the first people given this label, this name called Christians.
但是人第一次称他们为基督徒。
Why?
为什么呢?
Because people were talking so much about them.
因为人家在谈论他们。
That they say, hey, there's this group of people, there's something crazy happening there, you know.
哇，这一群人他们当中有极大的事情发生。
People are responding and people are getting healed, miracles are taking place.
很多人回应，很多有神迹奇事。
And it's so amazing that when the non-Christians talk about it,
所以很不可思议，当未信徒看他们的时候，
they need a way to refer to this group of people.
他们需要给他们一个名字。
Because they can't just say, hey, that group of people, right?
不然就说，哎，他们这样。
You keep saying, oh, those people, that people, which people? I don't know what you're talking about.
啊，不是这群人，那群人讲的是谁呀？
So they said, we will call them Christians because they are of Jesus Christ.
那我们就称他们为基督徒，因为他们是跟随耶稣的。
So they came out that term Christians.
所以就有了基督徒这个词。
So that's why this is so significant.
所以这非常重要。
So people had to talk about them because they saw these amazing things happening.
他们看到很多人谈论他们，因为他们看到神迹奇事。
So we see God's power on them.
我们看到神的大能与他们同在。
But beyond that, we see how the Antioch church was also spirit-led because they followed the Holy Spirit's direction.
另外，我们也看到他们是圣灵带领的，因为他们跟随圣灵的指引。
Now in Acts chapter 13, verses 2 to 3.
使徒行传十三章二到三节。
While they were worshipping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them. So after they had fasted and prayed, they placed their hands on them and sent them off.
他们在侍奉主和禁食的时候，圣灵说，要为我分派巴拿巴和扫罗去做我照他们做的工作。于是他们禁食祷告，给巴拿巴和扫罗按手，然后派遣他们走了。
See, what we see here is that there's a sensitivity to the Holy Spirit.
所以我们看到他们对圣灵非常敏锐。
That when the Holy Spirit speaks, they are able to perceive that and hear it.
当圣灵说话的时候，他们能够感受到，能够听到。
But beyond that, when they heard this prompting from the Holy Spirit,
但除了他们听到圣灵的感动的时候，
they continue to pray and fast and depend on His direction.
他们继续的禁食祷告，依靠他的指引。
Why do they continue to pray?
为什么要继续的听进？祷告呢?
Because the Bible says the heart is deceitful above all things.
因为圣经说我们的人心是诡诈的。
Meaning that we cannot trust our own desires.
是不能够信靠我们自己心里所想的。
So they continue to pray and to fast because they want to trust in the Holy Spirit's direction.
所以他们继续的禁食祷告，想要依靠圣灵的方向。
And after they had heard that, then they were convicted of that, they sent Paul and Barnabas out.
就当他们集体听到有这个信念以后，才分派他们出去。
This was them being spirit-led.
就是他们被圣灵引导。
They didn't do something just because they thought it's a good idea.
他们不单只是说哦，我们自己以为这样做比较好就做。
It was not just their own planning.
不是自己的筹划。
It was the Holy Spirit's direction.
而是圣灵的方向。
See, in this passage, being spirit-led is so important.
这里讲到被圣灵引导是很重要。
So much so that it's recorded what kind of a person Barnabas was.
好像哦，也是这样描述巴拿巴的。
Acts 11:24 says, Barnabas was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and faith.
使徒行传十一章二十四节这么说，这巴拿巴原是个好人，满有圣灵和信心。
What does it mean to be full of the Holy Spirit?
充满圣灵是什么呢？
This is something that, well, honestly, very often the church gets it wrong.
这是有时候我们会有误解的地方。
Because we always focus on being spirit-filled.
因为我们觉得我们只是专注于被圣灵充满。
But there's so much more than that.
但是还有更多。
Realize this, my point is this, is that we must not just be spirit-filled, we must be spirit-led.
我们不但是要让圣灵充满，也要让圣灵带领指引我们。
There is a big difference between spirit-filled and spirit-led.
圣灵充满跟圣灵带领是有区别的。
And only when you have both, then you can say you are full of the Holy Spirit.
只有你两样都有，才能说你是充满圣灵。
Now what's the difference?
有什么不同呢？
Many times people say, oh, I want to be filled with the Holy Spirit.
很多人说我想要让圣灵充满我。
Wow, pray for me, you know, I come to church, you're worshiping, I start to shiver, I start to cry, or I start to manifest.
然后在教会里面祷告敬拜的时候，突然间圣灵的彰显。
I want to be filled with the gifts of the Holy Spirit, I want to speak in tongues, I want to prophesy.
然后有圣灵的恩赐，让我能够说方言，能够说预言。
All that is good.
这些都很好。
But the question is, are you being led by the Holy Spirit in your life?
但是问题是你的生命当中有被圣灵带领吗？
See, since we had the encounter weekend over the last two weekends,
过去两周我们有经历神一会。
Those of you who have attended already, I've been making different changes to the curriculum.
然后你知道我做了一些修改。
One thing that we've always focused at the Encounter Weekend is about the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
其实我们专注的就是圣灵的浇灌。
To be filled with His power and His gifts.
让圣灵的恩赐大能充满我们。
Which is very important.
非常重要。
But I also introduce something else now.
但是现在我要讲另外一个主题内容。
Before we teach about the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
当我们讲到圣灵浇灌的时候。
There's a lesson first called the indwelling of the Holy Spirit.
在那之前有另外一课叫圣灵的内住。
See, sometimes we just focus on I want the gifts, the power and all that.
有时候我们只是专注我们想要恩赐想要大能
But we need the indwelling of the Holy Spirit so that in every aspect of our lives we will follow His leadership.
但我们需要圣灵的内住好在每一个状况我们都需要跟随他的带领
See, at the end of the day,
所以最终的话
So what if you can prophesy, you can speak in tongues?
如果能够说方言说预言又能怎样呢
But yet your life is not led by the Holy Spirit. You continue to lead your own life, you continue to live in sin.
如果你的生命没有让圣灵带领从自己过自己的生活活在罪里面
A pastor once said this.
一个牧师曾经这么说
So what if you can speak in tongues or you can prophesy in English or Chinese?
如果你可以说方言用说预言 又能怎样呢
You still curse and gossip.In English or Chinese.
你还是说一些污言秽语啊。
What's the point if you are filled, you focus on all these gifts?
如果你专注这些恩赐。
But your life is not being transformed.
但你的生命没有得到转化。
See, there's a big difference there.
所以这有一个很大的不同。
Antioch was full of the Holy Spirit.
所以安提阿教会是充满圣灵的。
Because they move in the gifts and the power of the Holy Spirit.
因为他们靠着神的恩赐，圣灵的恩赐大能。
But at the same time.
同时。
They also followed his leadership and direction.
他们也是跟随圣灵的指引带领。
See, some of us, we will say, oh yes, we'll minister, we'll move in the power of the Holy Spirit.
是哦，我要是行，靠着圣灵的大能而行。
But when the Holy Spirit calls you to do something, will you do it?
那圣灵如果叫你做些事情，你会去做吗？
When the Holy Spirit leads you to say, go and do something, or go and take this step of faith, will you actually listen?
如果圣灵带你说你要踏出这信心的一步，你会听吗？
So that's the first thing I want to share with us.
这是第一件要分享的。
The purpose-driven church must firstly be spirit-led.
使命的教会第一必须要是圣灵引导。
And on that note, this then leads into the second characteristic.
然后讲到第二个特征。
Is that the purpose-driven church must also be obedient.
使命教会必须要是存心遵从的教会。
You will only be truly spirit-led when you're obedient.
当你真正能够被圣灵引导，只有你遵从的时候才会发生。
Because sometimes the Holy Spirit will lead you to do things that you really do not want to.
因为有时候圣灵会带你做一些你不想做的事情。
So let's look at the Antioch Church.
我们看一下安提阿教会。
They were obedient in every aspect.
他们是全然的遵守的。
Now when you talk about obedience,
讲到遵从
there's of course obedience to God.
当然会遵从神。
And that is very paramount. That's important.
非常重要。
But remember, God is a God of community.
但神也是一个群体的神。
And last week, Pastor Roland taught us.
This,
that we are put in a community and there needs to be obedience to our earthly leaders as well.
我们是被放在一个群体里面，也要遵从我们世上的领袖。
Because often it's through our obedience to our earthly authorities that we're able to demonstrate obedience to God.
因为是通过我们遵从世上的领袖来彰显我们对神的遵从。
So how do we see this in the Church of Antioch?
我们在安提阿教会怎么看到这点呢？
Remember, like I said, they were started by the lay people of the area.
刚才讲到他们是在那个地区一般的信徒开始的教会。
And amazing things were happening.
他们当中发生神迹奇事。
And when these things happened, the church in Jerusalem sent Barnabas to go down and basically provide some leadership and guidance.
然后在耶路撒冷的教会听到他们的消息以后，差派巴拿巴和扫罗过去。
So in Acts chapter 11, verse 22, and then 25 to 26.
在使徒行传11章22节，还有25到26节这么说。
So news of what was happening reached the church in Jerusalem. They sent Barnabas to Antioch. Then Barnabas went to Tarsus, looked for Saul, and when he found him, brought him to Antioch. So for a whole year, the two of them met with the church and taught great numbers of people.
这风声传到耶路撒冷教会的人耳中，他们就打发巴拿巴和安提亚到安提亚去。他又往大树去找扫罗，找着了，就带他到安提亚去。他们足有一年，和教会一同聚集，教导了许多人。
So Barnabas and Paul went to Antioch as earthly authorities of the church, as leaders of the church as a whole.
所以巴拿巴和保罗是代表地上的权柄教会去到那边的。
But when they got to Antioch, they were not rejected by the people, but were welcomed by them.
他们去到安提阿以后，那里人并没有拒绝他们，而是欢迎他们。
This is actually quite amazing, you know.
这是很奇妙的。
Why would I say that?
为什么这么说呢？
Because if anything, the people there in Antioch had experienced God's power in such a magnificent way.
因为安提阿教会已经大大经历神的大能。
They could have said, hey,What do you all know? You all haven't been here. You haven't seen the things we've seen. You've not experienced the things we've experienced.
他们可以说你是谁呢？你又没有看到我们所看到的，经历我们所经历的。
So what if you come from Jerusalem?
如果你从耶路撒冷来又怎样?
We are the ones who are first called Christians.
我们是第一个被称为基督徒的。
We are the model.
我们是榜样。
They didn't say that.
他们并没有这么说。
Instead, they welcome Paul and Barnabas.
而是他们欢迎巴拿巴和保罗。
And they submitted themselves to their teaching and their leadership.
他们顺服他们的教导还有指引。
Like I said just now,
就像我刚才提到的。
If you want to truly express obedience to God,
如果要真正体现我们对神的尊崇
It takes the form of obedience to our earthly leaders as well.
就是要从遵从世上的权威开始
Romans chapter 13 verse 1 says this.
罗马书十三章第一节这么说
Let everyone be subject to governing authorities, for there is no authority except that which God has established. The authorities that exist have been established by God.
在上有权柄的人人要顺服，因为没有权柄不是来自神的，掌权的都是神所立的。
So we see how the Antioch church would obey their earthly leaders.
我们看到安提阿教会顺服他们世上的权柄。
But beyond that, we see how they obey God directly as well.
我们也看到他们直接的遵从神。
And the best example is in Acts chapter 13 verses 2 to 3 when they send Paul out.
最好的例子就是在使徒行传十三章里面，当他们派保罗出去的时候。
Now remember, Paul and Barnabas, the Holy Spirit spoke and said, send Paul and Barnabas out as missionaries.
因为圣灵对他们说，你要派巴拿巴和保罗出去做宣教士。
Now how did they respond?
他们怎么回应的？
Their response was to immediately pray and to seek the Lord.
他们就是立即的寻求神祷告。
And they prayed seriously about it.
他们是认真的寻求神。
Because they were prepared that truly, oh, let's send Paul and Barnabas out.
因为他们预备好了要派他们出去。
But what we have to be mindful of is this.
但是我们也要知道的是
Paul and Barnabas were great blessings to the church.
保罗和巴拿巴是对安提阿教会有很大祝福的。
In fact, they were an asset.
他们是资产是很好的。
So again, verse 26, it says, A whole year Barnabas and Saul met with the church and taught great numbers of people.
26节这么说，他们足有一年和教会一同聚集，教导了许多人。
Now, you know, at that point of time, I would totally understand if the people wanted to keep Paul and Barnabas for themselves.
所以我可以完全理解，如果教会想要留住巴拿巴和保罗他们自己。
They had been benefiting greatly from their ministry.
他们从他们的服事当中很大受益。
Paul and Barnabas were teaching them so much.
保罗和巴拿巴教导他们很多。
But when God said it's time to send them out, they obeyed.
但神说是时候派他们出去了，他们就遵从。
That is really a great example of obedience.
这是一个很好的遵从的榜样。
Meaning this, you know,
就是说
the obedience is truly, or how to say, we will truly know our obedience when that act costs us something.
我们只有当我们遵从的这个动作行为真正使我们要付出代价的时候。
Very often we get these two issues mixed up.
有时候我们可能混淆了这两个问题。
There's a difference between obedience and convenience.
就是遵从和方便是有区别的。
Many times we're not truly obedient.
有时候我们没有真正的遵从。
It's just a matter of convenience.
只是因为方便。
What I mean by that?
什么意思呢？
Meaning this, if God calls you to do something,
就是神叫你做一些事情。
Okay, let's say God gives us an instruction.
比如说给我们一个指示。
Okay, and the instruction is today, go to work.
我今天去工作。
Most of us, we are already going to go to work whether God said that anyway.
你原本就要去工作了，所以没有什么方便。
It was just a matter of convenience.
就是很方便啊。
But it's when God calls you to do something else that costs you something.
但如果神叫你去做一些让你付代价的事情。
That God now says, okay, go to work and I want you to set aside your own pride and go and preach the gospel there.
首先啊，你要去放下你的骄傲去传福音。
Now that becomes harder.
哇，这有点难了。
Because there's a price to be paid to do that.
因为现在有代价要付了。
And it's in that moment that you truly know whether you're obedient or not.
就在那一刻，你才知道你有没有顺服的心。
Now I'm not saying that, yeah, I mean, but there are some things that will be convenient.
但有一些是方便的。
I'm not saying that there's no aspect of obedience there.
但就在方便里面，并不说完全没有顺服。
But the point here is this.It may not be obedience to its full extent.
而是不是全然的顺服。
You will only know that obedience in its full extent when you step out to do something that costs you.
就当你需要付代价的时候，才可以得到这个顺服的考验。
Sending Paul and Barnabas out cost the Antioch church.
才派巴拿巴和保罗出去，使安提阿是需要付代价的。
They would have lost two great leaders, two great teachers.
他们会失去一个他们最好的领袖，最好的教师。
But they understood that the Christian faith is meant to be an outward one.
但是他们知道，在我们的基督徒信仰是要向外的。
And that's why they would obey and send the two of them out.
所以他们遵从，派他们出去。
So that's the second thing that's important, obedience.
这是第二点很重要，就是存心遵从。
So the purpose-driven church must be number one, spirit-led.
使命教会第一要被圣灵引导。
Number two, it must be obedient.
第二要存心尊崇。
And finally, number three.
第三
，the purpose-driven church must be generous.
使命教会必须要是慷慨解囊。
Now, what we also see is the Antioch church being very generous.
我们也看到安提阿教会非常的慷慨。
So let's look at verses 27 to 30 again.
我们看一下11:27-30.
During this time, some prophets came down from Jerusalem. One of them, named Agabus, stood up.And through the Holy Spirit predicted that a severe famine would spread over the entire Roman world. And the disciples, as each one was able, decided to provide help for their brothers and sisters living in Judea. This they did, sending their gift to the elders by Barnabas and Saul.
27节，当那些日子，有几位先知从耶路撒冷下到安提阿，内中有一位名叫雅加布，站起来，接着圣灵指示，普天下将有大饥荒，这是在克劳地年间果然实现了。于是门徒决定照个人的力量捐钱送去供给住在犹太的弟兄他们就这样做了托巴拿巴和扫罗的手送到众长老那里
See, whatever they were giving here is not for their own self.
所以他们捐出去的不是为了他们自己
Because this favor is an outward one.
因为这信心是向外的
They were giving in kind, they were giving in cash for the sake of the benefit of other people.
他们捐出他们的物质他们的金钱是为了别人能够受益
Because this faith is outward.
因为这信心是向外的。
And I want to point out a very interesting detail here.
我要指出很有趣的一个细节。
They didn't wait for a very long time before they gave.
他们并没有长时间等待才决定。
Read verse 29 again.
我们再读29节。
The disciples, as each one was able, decided to provide help for their brothers and sisters living in Judea.
于是门徒决定照个人的力量捐钱送去供给住在犹太的弟兄。
Now this is a very interesting word here, the word decided.
这里决定很有意思。
It didn't say each of them prayed about helping the people there.
并没有说门徒他们祷告要不要捐钱。
They didn't say that they fasted in order to before they gave.
或者是之前要禁食。
Now I'm not saying you shouldn't pray and fast.
但不是说不需要祷告禁食。
But I need to teach us something very important in our Christian faith.
而是要教导这里信仰里面很重要的一点。
There are some things in our faith, or in fact many things in our faith, you don't have to pray. Over, you don't have to pray one.
我们信仰里面很多事情是不需要祷告的。
But Christians like to hide behind this thing called pray.
但是我们想要有这样说，我要祷告，这样隐藏在后面。
So much so that generally when someone says, "Let me pray about it," it's just a Christian way of saying, "No, I won't do it."
就是我祷告，就是你是说一个委婉的方式，说我不要做。
I'm not saying all of us do that, but sometimes we don't really pray about it.
不是所有人都这样，但是有一些人就是啊，说我要祷告，实际上是说不。
But I want to settle this right now. There are many things you don't need to pray about one.
但是我这里说的是很多事情不需要祷告。
How?The pastor saying, "No, you pray about things."
啊，牧师说不需要祷告。
Absolutely, let me give you a few examples.
当然有几个例子。
Do you need to pray about whether you should live a holy life or not?
你需要祷告，需要所活一个圣洁的生命。
Do you need to seek God for direction? God, should I be holy or not?
你需不需要寻求神说神我需要圣洁吗
？You don't need to pray to God about that. You just need to live a holy life.
你不需要向神这样祷告，你只需要活出圣洁的生命。
Do we need to pray to God? God, should I commit sin or should I not commit sin?
你可以向神祷告说，我需要犯罪吗？还是不需要
？No need to pray about it.
不需要祷告的。
Just don't do it. Don't commit that sin.
不要犯罪就对了。
Do we need to pray to God as to God? Should I go and preach the gospel or not?
你可以需要向神祷告说，我需要传福音吗
？No need to pray one.
不需要祷告的。
The Bible already says so.
圣经已经说了。
You need to go and do it.
只是去做就可以了。
Do we need to pray as to God? Should I go and help those in need?
你需要祷告说，我需要帮助有需要的人吗
？No need.
不需要。
Just do it.
做就对了。
That's why.It says that they heard it and they decided themselves they were going to help the people there.
所以他们听到，他们就决定去帮助那些有需要的。
So let's not try and go into all these kind of things, you know.
所以我们不要躲藏在一个属灵的一个面具后面。
See, sometimes we are too. Sometimes I believe maybe we don't understand who God really is.
有时候我们可能不太了解神是谁。
See, sometimes yes, the Bible says God is our friend. We are friends of God.
神说哦，圣经说我们是神的朋友。
God is a loving heavenly father.
他是个慈爱的天父。
So sometimes we become very casual with God. Oh God, let me think about it.
所以哦，跟神就好像就是一个很不正式的一个关系。
But we forget that He is also called the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
但是他也是万王之王，万主之主。
When the King speaks, it is a command. It's an order.
当王说话的时候，就是一个诫命，一个法令。
In Christianity, one thing we learn very early on is this thing.
这就是我们很早就学到的事。
In fact, it's 10 things.
就是十件的。
What they call?
什么呢
？The 10 what?
是十个。
The 10 suggestions.
十个建议。
The 10 maybes.
十个可能。
No, the 10 commandments.
是十诫，十个诫命。
It's a command.
是一个诫命。
Meaning this, you know what's a command when it comes from God?
就是神说的就是诫命。
Basically, a command from God means doesn't matter what you think, it's a command. You
就是不管你是想法是什么，就是一个诫命，就要去做。
And sometimes we have forgotten that aspect.
有时候我们忘记神的这一方面。
Absolutely, God is a friend. God is a loving father that we can run to.
当然神是我们的朋友，我们的天父，我们可以走向他。
But don't ever forget He's our King as well.
但也不要忘记他是我们的王。
There are things He calls us to do is simply a command.
他叫我们做的有时候就是一个诫命。
And what's the only acceptable answer?
就是其中只有一个可以接受的答案就是
Yes, sir.
是的。
Don't ever forget that.
不要忘记这一点。
See, the people, the Antioch church, they are purpose-driven church because they understood this.
所以安提阿教会是使命教会，因为他们了解这一点。
When it's time to give and help other people, they say yes, sir. They decided for themselves.
是时候奉献帮助别人的时候，他们就决定去帮助。
They didn't have to go and pray about it. They say, God, I will do it.
不需要祷告说神，我就是要做，我决定要做。
So you see this that they were very generous with their own resources.
所以我们看到他们对自己的资源是很慷慨的。
They were generous with their financial resources.
不单是金钱方面的资源。
But they were also generous with their best resource.
当然对他们最好的资源他们也很慷慨
Like I said just now, Paul and Barnabas
就是保罗和巴拿巴
Now God didn't kind of like force them say you, God didn't take Paul and Barnabas away, you know
神并不是强迫拿走巴拿巴和保罗
It's not like suddenly wow, some kind of wow, angels came and then kidnapped Paul and Barnabas away
不是有天使来绑架巴拿巴和保罗
Look at Acts 13 verse 3
我们看一下《使徒行传》十三章第三节。
Then having fasted and prayed and laid hands on Paul and Barnabas, they sent them away.
于是他们进食祷告后，给巴拿巴和扫罗按手，然后派遣他们走了。
So it was the Antioch church that was willing to say, Paul and Barnabas, we send you away. We didn't say God call you to go. He said, no, we send you.
所以是安提阿教会说，我们愿意派你们出去。
They were very. That's a very generous heart right there.
这是个很慷慨的心。
And you know, the Bible talks so much about generosity.
曾经很多地方都讲到慷慨。
Proverbs 11:25.
箴言十一章二十五节。
A generous person will prosper, and whoever refreshes others will be refreshed.
慷慨待人必然丰裕，滋润人的，连自己也得滋润。
Perhaps maybe that's why the Antioch church experienced such great revival.
可能这可能也是安提阿教会经历复兴的原因。
Because those who are generous will prosper.
因为那些慷慨待人的必然丰裕。
Those who are committed to refreshing others will themselves be refreshed.
滋润人的自己也得滋润。
2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 6.
更多后书九章第六节。
The Bible says, remember this, whoever sows sparingly will reap sparingly, but whoever sows generously will reap generously.
圣经说还有一点，少种的少收，多种的多收。
So the Bible commands us to be generous people.
圣经有一个诫命，我们要慷慨待人。
But we have to understand how can we be generous people?
但我们如何成为慷慨的人呢？
Well, we have to go and understand the root of generosity.
我们就要了解慷慨的根源在哪里。
Now people often think that the root of generosity is wealth and riches.
很多人以为慷慨的根源是财富、金钱。
When you have a lot, then you're able to go and give.
你有很多就可以捐出去。
If you have a lot of money, you can go and give a lot of money.
有很多的钱就可以给予很多的钱。
Or if like the Antioch church, if you have a lot of leaders, you can go and send people out to go and serve.
比如说安提阿教会有很多的领袖，就可以差派领袖出去。
But if that's the case,
如果是这样的话，
if the root of generosity is wealth and riches,
如果慷慨的根源是在于财富的话，
that means all these Bible verses about generosity only applies to the rich.
那如果圣经真的讲到慷慨的只是适用于那些富人了，
and so how do you determine that?
那我们怎么决定呢？
So you come to church, you must declare, you know, how much is your, what's your annual salary, is it?
教会就要说，上报你每年的赚的钱是多少吗？
Then a certain amount and above, then, oh, these verses apply to you. If you earn below that, it doesn't apply to you.
就赚某个数目以上，这些是适用于你，不然就不适用于你吗？
No, that's not how we look at the Bible.
不是这样，不是这样。
The word of God is for every single disciple.
神的话是对每一个信徒说的。
See, the root of generosity is not riches or wealth.
所以慷慨的根源不是在于财富的多少
The root of generosity is trust in God
而是信靠神
That's why generosity is for all of us because all of us need to learn to trust in God
所以慷慨是对我们每个人说我们都需要信靠神
Since we're talking about trust
我们讲到信靠
Let's talk about the most famous scripture when it comes to trust
我们讲到信靠一个最有名的经文
Many of us, we receive cards with this people text us this verse, we bless us with this and so on and so forth
我们可能收到卡片上面有这个信息那个短信里面有这个信息
Many of us have memorized these verses
很多人可能也是背下来这个信息
Proverbs chapter 3 verses 5 and 6
箴言三章五到六节
Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit or acknowledge Him, and He will make your paths straight.
你要专心仰赖耶和华，不可以靠自己的聪明，在你一切所行的路上都要认定他，他必使你的道路平直。
Many people say, yeah, I love this verse.
So, 我喜欢这节经文。
God, I want to hold this verse to remind me to trust in you.
我要记住这节经文来提醒我依靠你。
Do you know this verse on trust comes with an assignment?
但是这个信号是有一个应用的。
An assignment to truly demonstrate that trust.
有个应用来展示你对神的信号。
It's further down in verses 9 to 10 of Proverbs 3.
这是在下面的9到10节。
Proverbs 3, 9 to 10 says, Honor the Lord with your wealth. With the first fruits of all your crops, then your barns will be filled to overflowing, and your vats will brim over with new wine.
箴言三章九到十节这么说：你要以财物和一切出熟的土产尊崇耶和华，这样你的仓库必充满有余，你的酒池也有新酒盈溢。
So God is calling us, say, if you really want to truly trust in Him,
他说如果你真的信靠我。
The best demonstration is with our wealth.
最好的展现就是你的用你的金钱。
That's the simplest and the first step for us to take.
这是第一步最简单的一步。
And it says first fruits, you know?
就是初熟的果实。
You see, the word fruit here, of course, for those at that point in time where people harvest fruits and grain and so on.
但那时候他们有庄稼，有收割。
First fruits means whatever they gain, the first aspect goes to God.
初熟就是他们所收割的第一部分就交给神。
You think about it, for us today, our harvest is, let's say, our salary.
但我们今天我们的收割可能是我们的工资。
Most of us, our first fruits, the first aspect of it, I put aside a little bit for me or for my family or for whatever needs I have.
我们可能收到第一份工资就是先给我们自己或是我们的家人。
But God says no, you put the first part for God.
但神说是第一部分要交给他。
So you truly want to trust in the Lord?
如果真的想要信靠他。
We truly say, if you are truly Christian, say, God, I want to claim Proverbs 3, 5, and 6.
所以我想要箴言三章五到六节在我生命当中。
I want to be a Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 Christian.
我想要活出这样的经文。
Then God gives you an immediate assignment. Honor the Lord with your wealth.
神的应用就是你用金钱来尊崇他。
Because honoring Him with our wealth is where we learn what generosity is.
因为金钱尊崇他就学习如何的慷慨。
See, giving generously is a command.
所以慷慨的给予是一个诫命。
But it's a command that will only be obeyed if we trust in God.
但只有当我们信靠神的时候才能够遵从。
The Christian who obeys is the one who trusts God.And the Christian who trusts God is the one who is willing to obey.
遵从的基督徒是信靠神的，信靠神的基督徒也是愿意遵从的。
See, all these three things I'm sharing today come hand in hand.
所以这三点都是相辅相成。
So what are the three things I share today?
今天我要分享的三点是什么呢？
The purpose-driven church must be.
使命教会必须是。
Number one, spirit-led.
第一，圣灵引导。
Number two, obedient.
第二，存心遵从。
And number three, generous.
第三是慷慨解囊。
What does it mean to be spirit-led?
被圣灵引导是什么呢？
Or we can only be spirit-led when we live obediently to the Lord.
只有当我们遵从神的时候才能够被圣灵引导。
We are only obedient when we choose to live a spirit-led life.
只有我们决定被圣灵引导才能够遵从。
We will be generous when we choose to have a spirit-led life.
当我们决定被圣灵引导的时候才能够慷慨。
And when we are spirit-led, we will be generous.
当我们被圣灵引导的时候，我们就会成为慷慨的人。
All these things are interconnected.
所以这些都是互相联系的。
And I want you to remember all these three things.
我们要记住所有这三点。
We have to be spirit-led. We have to be obedient. We have to be generous.
我们要被圣灵引导，要尊崇，要慷慨。
Tell the person beside you, say, "Be spirit-led."
对身边人说，要被圣灵引导。
Tell someone else, "Be obedient."
对另外的人说，要遵崇。
If you can, find another person now and say, "Be generous."
找第三个人说，要慷慨。
So today, this message, this sermon, this part of the teaching is really the framework for what I want to share.
那今天这个分享是我的一个框架，我接下来要分享的。
Because next, like I said, we're going to get into this moment of talking about family matters.
那接下来我们讲的是我们的家务事了。
啊，家事啊，不是家的问题、啊。没有问题啊。
好事。
OK， 好事，好事。OK， 谋满台啊。OK， so I want to share with you some things that I'm very happy.
我讲我 很高兴的一个事情
，because as I put this message together today，
当我在预备今天的讲章的时候
，my dream is that our church will always be a purpose-driven church。
我的梦想是我们的教会永远是被圣灵引导的。
And I don't think we are exactly where we need to be yet。
我们可能还没有到我们想到的地方。
But I'm very happy that we are on our way。
但是我们很高兴我们正在前进的路上。
And I'm seeing many aspects of our church where we are being spirit-led, we're being obedient, we're being generous.
我看到教会很多方面都是被圣灵引导，都是遵从神，都是慷慨。
And I'm not saying we were not like that in the past.
并不是我们过去不是这样。
But I'm saying more and more, we're learning what it means to be spirit-led, to be obedient, to be generous.
而是我们现在越做越好。
So these are some of the things I want to start sharing with us and share with us how we see this happening in our church.
然后我要分享我们这些事如何在教会里面彰显的。
The first thing I want to do right now.
第一件我要做的是
I want to give us an update on our missions and faith pledges.
给我们一个宣教信心韧性的一个更新一个动向。
Now for those of us who are newer, you may not know what the MFP is or the Missions Faith Pledge.
如果你在我们教会比较新的话，可能不知道宣教信心韧性是什么。
In our church, every time it comes to offering, we have two colors, red color and blue color, right?
每次我们教会要奉献的时候，有两个有红色的，有蓝色的格子。
Red color is our regular tithing and offering.
红色的是我们立常十一奉献。
It's our 10% to give to the Lord.
就是我们的十分之一。
Whatever we collect, that goes into our general operations of the church.
我们在这里收的就是给我们教会一般的运作。
So to run programs, the upkeep of our buildings, salary of the staff, and so on.
我们的维修、我们的活动，还有我们的工资。
But since our early days, we established this blue color section called the Missions Faith Pledge now.
但是我们开始的时候也有这样一个基金叫就是蓝色的。
We always say this is over and above our regular giving.
就是我们在立常十一奉献之外的。
And whatever we collect here is for the purpose of missions.
我们这里说的是为我们宣教的工作。
Now, last year I started talking to the church a lot about missions.
然后去年我讲到对教会讲到很多关于宣教的。
And remember, I told our leadership team that this year I want to do 4 special collections for missions.
我对我的领袖说，今年我要做四次的宣教信心奉献。
I want to announce to you that I failed.
我要跟你说的是，我没有做到。
I've only done one collection so far this year.
今年我只是做了一次。
If you all recall, we called for a collection earlier in the year.
如果你记得的话，就是年前的时候有这样一个筹款。
But maybe let me explain to you a little bit why there's only been one collection so far.
但是我要解释为什么只有一次呢
？Now, I just want to give you an update on where this collection is going.
我给你带来一些最新的动向。
I want to share with you as the data as of the start of September because I shared this with the leaders at the start of September.
这个数据是截止于九月份的，是跟领袖会议的时候分享的。
Okay, so let me show you some. Let's put up the chart there.
我们看一下上面的一些图表。
Now, all this is with effect from the start of September. Okay,
这是九月份之前的。
So in 2022 at the start of September.
在2022年9月份的第一个礼拜
Our Missions Faith Pledge collection was about 723,000.
我们宣教信心韧线收到的是72万3千。
And as the church and as the whole world moved out of the pandemic in 2023, we saw there's a slight increase to 740,000.
然后在2023年冠军疫情结束的时候，我们收到的是74万。
Now let's look at 2023 to 2024.
我们看一下2023年到24年。
Okay, 2024, we gave this, started talking more about missions, and I gave a call this year to give for missions.
然后24年我们开始讲到宣教，讲要奉献给宣教。
How much do you think he has jumped by?
你觉得我们收了多少呢？
See, initially it was about 2.3%. How many percent do you think it's grown by?
以前是 2.3% 的增长。
4%, some people say 4%.
有些人说 4% 的增长。
How many say 10%?
10%.
20%, 50%?
20%, 50%.
I want to announce to you that this giving has increased by 300% over.
我要报告的是，我们增长有340%的增长。
All of you have given a total of 3.2 million for the purpose of missions.
我们一起给了3,257,000。
And I shared this with the cell leaders.
我也和小组组长分享。
What is even more encouraging?
更加受鼓励的是
，is that the red bag, our regular tithing offering, has not dropped.
就是我们十一奉献没有降。
It still has some adjustment. Usually it's plus minus, but usually point something percent one.
就是一般会有一些小的幅度。
But basically, meaning this, our regular giving has not changed, but all of you have many of us have given even more for the purpose of missions.
就是我们立常十一奉献没有改变多少，但是我们有额外的又多了300多万。
And to me, this is a sign that we're learning what it means to be spirit-led, to be obedient, and to be generous.
所以对我来说，这就是一个。最好的例子就是被圣灵带领遵从慷慨的一个例子。
And all this is only possible because of you, because of the church.
这有可能是因为你，因为我们教会。
So I want to just quickly say this that I'm of course I'm thankful to the Lord and I'm thankful for all of you.
所以我很快说的是，我很感谢上帝，也感谢你们。
But as SP also, I want to say that I'm very proud of this church.
就是作为主任牧师，我为这个教会感到很骄傲。
So can you please put your hands together and give yourselves a round of applause?
给自己一个掌声，哈利路亚。
Now with that, I want to share with you a little bit about the usage of these funds.
那我们想一下这个基金的用途。
Now I want to be very clear about something. Our Mission Faith Pledge amount there is only for the purpose for missions.
宣教信心任性的捐款只是用于宣教。
It's not something that I can draw down and say I'll use it to go and pay other people's salary or run a local program.
不可以用这个钱来付工资或者是做活动。
Legally, it's a designated fund, so we must dedicate it for that purpose.
所以这个是法定的这样一个指定的一个用途。
But I want to share with you some of the things that we've used. Because some of you say, wow, there's a lot of money. What do we do with that?
哇，首先收了很多钱，我们该怎么做呢？
Well, firstly, we use it to support our own FCBC missions efforts.
那首先是支持我们自己宣教的事工。
We've been having many trips this year.
我们这周有今年有很多的去外的一个旅程。
You've been hearing, I've been going to Timor a lot. I've been going to different places to minister and so on.
我去了东帝汶好几次，还有其他的地方。
In fact, this Tuesday, I'm bringing another team to Timor Leste. I'll be there for 2 weeks.
然后这个周二我也会带一个团队去到东帝汶两周。
Before the year ends, there'll be Pastor Wee Long and Christopher are going to be leading a team to Nepal.
然后在年底之前，韦伦牧师、金银牧师也会带一个团队去到尼泊尔。
Touch International right now is in Japan doing some humanitarian work.
出来国际现在就在日本做人道主义的工作。
Next month they'll go to Japan again for another project, and they also go to Nepal for another project.
然后下个月他们会到日本，然后再去到尼泊尔。
And December there'll be another humanitarian trip they're sending over to Vietnam.
然后十二月份的时候也会一个团队去到越南。
And in the recent in the last season, as you know, the typhoon hit our area very bad. This region.
就过去的一个季节，这个地区有受到台风的侵蚀。
We've been sending a lot of financial assistance to different countries such as Nepal.
我们去到很多的国家金援帮助，比如说尼泊尔。
And we're going to be giving to Vietnam as well.
然后也要捐给越南。
See, whatever, I mean, the principle that my dad always taught us about our Missions Faith Pledge.
关于我们宣教信心任性的，我父亲教导我一个原则，就是
He said, whatever we collect is meant to be sent out.
我们收到的钱就是要给出去的。
It's not for us to keep and then keep it more and more and more.
不是让我们来存的。
Beyond that, we give to many of our missions partners as well.
但我们要给我们很多的宣教的伙伴。
We have partners in Timor Leste.
我们在东帝汶有一些伙伴。
We contribute to this organization called Transformation Alliance, which is one of our sort of like our organization for missions work there.
就是给转化联盟这个机构，就是我们在那边事工的一个合作伙伴。
We contribute to the salary of the director there as well.
然后也给转化联盟合场主任的他的工资。
We support other mission agencies such as YWAM.
但还有其他宣教机构，比如说青年使命团。
We even continue to contribute financially to one of the former directors of YWAM Singapore.
但也资助前青年使命团的总干事。
He served alongside with my dad many years ago, and they're good friends.
他和我父亲就是多年一起同工，是好朋友。
But when I took on the role as SP, I said, "Hey, let's continue to contribute to his work."
当我作为主任牧师的时候，我说我们要继续的资助他。
Beyond that, there are other works there. We even contribute to the Methodist Mission Society with what we're doing in Cambodia.
当我们也支持在柬埔寨的一个卫理公会宣教协会。
The point here is that all this that we collect is not for ourselves.
是我讲的是，我们这里所收到的不是为我们自己。
It's not for us to get rich.
不是让我们更富有。
But it's for us to be a blessing outside of our own church.
而是在我们教会之外成为一个祝福。
So that's really the heartbeat of our church.
这是我们教会的心态。
So with that, right, this is what I'm gonna do.
这里我要做的是。
This weekend, I'm gonna start. I'm using this weekend to call for a final round of special collection for this year.
这个周末我会开始今年最后一轮的一个募款。
And I want all of us from the period of November all the way to December to use that period to be giving to the Missions Faith Pledge.
就是利用十一和十一月份捐给宣教信心任性。
Whatever the Lord places upon your heart.
无论神把什么数字放在你心里。
But it is time for us to continue giving.
是我们时候继续的募款。
And you may say, "Wow, you know, Pastor, we already collected quite a lot. Do we still need to keep collecting?" Absolutely, because there's a lot of work to be done and blessing that the nations around us need.
但需要，因为外面万国的需要很大。
So with that, I want to share with you some of the things that we need to be contributing to.
就我们讲到我们需要奉献的一些地方。
So from here, I want to talk to you about something exciting that will be happening next year.
就是明年会发生的很令人兴奋的事。
So of course, next year, we're going to be having the G12 Asia Conference again in August.
我们在八月份会有 G12 亚洲大会。
And this weekend, we're announcing the dates.
然后这个周末我们会给我们大家日期。
G12 Asia Conference 2025 will be from the 19th to the 22nd of August.
2025年 G12 亚洲大会会是8月19到22日。
Now, If you look at your calendars, there's something interesting you'll notice.
如果你看日历的话，就会发现有趣的事。
It's a little bit different.
有点不一样了。
This time is Tuesday to Friday.
这一轮是星期二到星期五。
Now let me explain to us why.
我解释为什么。
One thing that we've notice, because the G12 Asia Conference is also for the G12 Asia family.
但 G12 亚洲大会也是 G12 的大家庭。
Many of the international community, they need to start leaving Friday night or Saturday morning, to go back home to run their own services.
因为他们需要星期五或星期六早上回到他们家里的教会去做聚会。
So when our conferences were running all the way, like, you know, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
所以我们如果有星期四、星期五、星期六、星期天。
Many of the pastors had to start flying back.
很多的牧师就要提前离开了。
In fact, one year, I want to tell you about this great, this very faithful man.
然后我讲到其中一年有这样一位忠心的仆人。
Pastor Lee Sambam from the coordinator of Korea.
就是韩国的牧师李桑班。
One year, this is what happened.
然后有一年发生什么事情？
He came for the conference.
他来到我们的大会。
Thursday, Friday, Saturday night, he flies back home.
就是星期四、星期五，然后星期五、星期六晚上，
星期六晚上，
他飞回家。
He reached back Sunday morning.
然后星期天到家。
Run the services.
然后主持了聚会。
Then get on a plane and fly back to Singapore.
然后又重新飞回新加坡。
So that he can attend, finish the other meetings that he needs to attend at the conference.
好像能够还能够参与其他的特会的会议。
But that's what a lot of our international community does for the sake of this conference.
这是我们很多的海外的参与者为这个特会所做的。
So we said this year, let's bless them by making it Tuesday to Friday, where that's a formal program.
所以我们说我们要祝福他们，把时间定为星期二到星期五。
I mean, some may want to stay on, have holiday here. Some may need to rush back. They are free to do so.
但他们可以继续多留几天，或者是回家。
So we'll start Tuesday night all the way to Friday.
所以星期二晚上开始到星期五。
Now, what's the other reason why it's also more days?
另外一个原因为什么会有多这样的多天数呢？
Next year the conference is going to be half day only, not full day.
就是明年我们的会议是半天，不是整天。
No more 9:30 a.m. to 10 p.m.
不是九点半十点开始。
Okay. We will start after lunch.
是午餐之后开始。
Until evening, and that's the arrangement for every day.
然后到晚上，这是每天的安排。
The reason for this also, firstly, it makes it easier for everyone.
但原因就是这样，大家比较容易来参会。
Secondly, during the mornings, we're going to have some strategic meetings with some of the countries and pastors as well.
但在早上有时间和其他的牧者、其他国家的牧者来参会。
And of course, for those of us, I mean, now we don't have to take leave for that segment also lah.
但这是早上的时候也不需要申请假期这样子。
But since it's Tuesday to Friday,
所以这是星期五到星期天。
Again, I'll let you know more information as it comes closer.
所以这星期二到星期五我们会给大家更多的详情。
But there's going to be a special program just for FCBC on the 23rd to 24th of August, which is the Saturday, Sunday.
那就是23到24号星期六、星期天会为我们教会特别准备的安排。
Now, one thing I've been thinking of quite a lot.
是我一直在想的事。
Is that every year when we run our conferences?
每年我们在做我们的大会。
Many FCBC members are very busy serving in one way or another.
我们的很多会友都会以某种方式来服侍。
And sometimes we don't get to kind of really sit through everything and receive.
有时候我们没有好好的领受。
So I want to give a dedicated time with some of the international speakers and team for them to come and minister to us.
所以我要有一些特定的时间，让我们的海外的讲员也为我们服侍。
So that's why we're going to have that special program over the Saturday and Sunday.
所以星期六、星期天有这样一个特别的安排。
But again, this is our assignment as our church.
这是我们教会的一个任务。
God has called us for whatever reason to be the coordinating church for G12 Asia.
神叫我们成为亚洲的。就是亚洲的协调员。
Honestly, after all these years of running our conferences,
就是我们做了这么多年了。
I really cannot understand why thousands of people want to come and learn from us.
就是很不了解为什么会有成千上万的人想过来和我们学习。
All I can say is the grace of God and the power of God.
我能说的是，真的是神的恩典，神的大能。
And when we run this conference,
当我们举办这个特会的时候
，it costs a fair bit of money to accommodate so many people.
当然也会有很多的代价，金钱方面。
In fact, that's one of the reasons why we do it every other year now.
所以现在我们是隔年在做。
Because it costs us over $1 million to put a conference like that together.
因为要做这个大会，可能会花100万。
Beyond that, we also spend about $200,000+ in terms of sponsorships for developing nations.
但我们也有20万来资助那些来自贫穷国家的与会者。
We cover their flights, we cover their accommodations, so that they can come and be blessed.
然后帮助他们的机票还有住宿，好让他们能够得到祝福。
I mean, these are the things that our mission faith pledge goes into contributing to.
所以这是我们宣教信心正线的钱来用的用途。
So that's one program coming up next year, the G12 Asia Conference.
这是明年的一个项目 ，G12 亚洲大会。
The second thing that will happen next year.
然后明年第二件事是
I want to bring you a quick update about our FCBC Japan building.
是我们坚信基督教会的日本建堂。
I shared with us last year that we had bought a plot of land in Japan.
去年我分享了我们在日本买了一块地皮。
And we're currently working out the designs and everything.
现在我们在看设计。
But we're looking at starting construction in May or June of 2025.
然后2025年五六月份的时候可能开始建造。
Construction will take about 10 months-ish, and so at the start of 2026, we'll have our new building ready there.
可能会建造大概十个月，然后2026年开始的时候就会完工。
So again, much of this funds goes into that building as well.
所以这个倾销区增建的钱可能也会在那边。
And that building is not just going to be for the sake of running FCBC services.
它那个建堂不单只是我们教会的聚会。
But it's also for, in fact, I want to kind of make that as an office for Touch International over there.
也是我们出海国际的一个办公室。
Because that region is one that really needs a lot of humanitarian work.
因为那个地区需要很多的人道主义帮助。
So that's something that's coming up.
这是明年的事情。
And I'll be calling us to continue to give so that we can have funds for this building.
我继续的呼召大家继续的奉献，好让我们有足够的钱。
Now, since we're talking about building, I just want to make a separate announcement, related but not directly related.
那现在就是讲一个相关的报告。
I just want to make a very quick mention, but it's an important update about our Gateway Theatre Building Fund.
就是讲到嘉伟剧院建坛基金。
Now, Gateway Theatre has been built for many years already.
我们已经建了很多年了。
But this building fund for Gateway Theatre has been left open all this while.
那这个基金目前还在开着。
Because there have been members of our church who pledged to give over a duration of time and they wanted to continue to contribute.
因为会有他们认线，他们还在继续的在奉献在里面。
But the leadership of the church has felt that we've opened it for long enough.
但是我们教会领袖觉得这个账号已经开了很久了。
So with effect from 1st November.
所以从11月1号开始。
It is going to be redesignated as a general building fund.
会重新指定作为一般建堂的基金
means it's still for the purpose of buildings
就是还是用于建堂
but not just Gateway Theatre
那不但是嘉伟剧院
could be for our own needs here at TC and so on
可能是我们自己出爱的建设等等
okay so that is just to let you know that this will be happening from 1st November
所以这是从11月1号开始奏效
but let me just now kind of bring this service to let it land on what I want to share
然后我们再讲一下我们下面要提到的
nowAt the end of the day, really, this is our heartbeat as a church.
这是我们教会的心。
We want to be a purpose-driven church.
我们想要成为一个使命教会。
And it means we have to be spirit-led, we have to be obedient, we have to be generous.
就是要圣灵引导，要尊崇，要慷慨。
I want to share with you firstly about Japan.
我首先分享日本。
Just now, I shared with you about this building and everything.
然后日本的建坛。
Now,I'll show you a picture. This is the picture of the land that we brought. Last year, we brought a team there to pray over the land and so on.
这是这个图片，我们去年买的这块地皮。
You know, this was one of the scariest projects for me ever.
这对我来说是最胆战心惊的一个项目。
Because I'm still a relatively new senior pastor.
因为我作为主任牧师还是算是新的。
I've run programs and everything, but I've never had to make a call that we're going to spend something like that.
我虽然做一些活动，但是从来没有花这么大的钱做这个项目。
I mean, the land cost $2+ million plus construction easily is a $10 million project.
可能是会花上千万的。
I've never made that kind of decision before.
从来没有过这样大的决定。
But,I never even considered it.
从来没有考虑过。
But I remember when the Lord spoke to me about our work in Japan.
但是神对我说话关于我们在日本的事工。
And basically he asked me, are we just kind of passing through, or are we going to say that we're committed to the work there?
所以我们只是在那边是过客吗？还是我们是真正的委身？
Because one of the things about, I mean, Japan has its own struggles in the area of missions work.
但日本在宣教方面有自己的挣扎。
And I felt God challenging.Me in this area.
我觉得神对我挑战在这方面。
Just because it's difficult, are you going to stop?
就是有困难，你就要停止了吗
？And I said no.
我说不。
And he said, if that's the case, then the church needs to plant itself there.
如果是这样的话，那你就需要把自己驻扎在那里。
And I said, okay, let's stop renting. Let's start working on getting our own place.
好，那我们就不要再租了，我们要有自己的地方了。
And God said, go and do that. And I mean, I followed the leading of the Holy Spirit. I obeyed.
神说好，那就这么做，那我就顺服神的带领。
And our church has been generous to give to contribute to that.
然后我们教会很慷慨的捐款，然后也是捐款到那边。
But I want you to know that this is really the heartbeat of how our church operates.
但是这是我们教会运作的方式、心态。
In fact, after this, I'm going to ask I need your help both here and over at Suntec.
但之后我需要你的帮助，在这里，在新达城。
Later on, I'm going to get you to do a simple recording.
要做一个简单的一个录音。
Because this coming weekend is FCBC Sendai's 10th anniversary.
因为这个来临的周末是我们教会仙台的十周年纪念。
We planted our church in Sendai 10 years ago.
我们在十年前建立了在仙台的教会。
But our work in Japan began maybe I think 11 or 12 years ago.
但我们在日本的事工是11、12年前开始的。
Do you know how it started?
你知道是怎么开始的吗？
It started because of the tsunami.
开始是因为有大的海啸。
There was a great tsunami, the great earthquake that resulted in tsunami, then the nuclear power plant there, there was a meltdown and everything. It was a very bad situation.
那时候有大的海啸、大的地震，然后有核电厂的泄漏等等。
When that at that point of time, our missionaries there, Pastor Caleb and Christina have been always, you know, talking to my dad saying, "Hey, when can we go?"
那时候发生这样的事情的时候 ，Pastor Caleb Christina 一直在跟宽恕球牧师说，我们什么时候可以去服侍那边
？When the earthquake happened, the church sensed that's the time.
但地震发生的时候，教会就说是时候了。
And when we sent our teams up after the earthquake,
当地震发生，我们派我们的团队去那边。
It was a very difficult situation.
是个很困难的时候。
In fact, it was very dangerous.
是很危险的时候。
I want to share with you this.
要跟你分享的是。
Because the Fukushima nuclear power plant was affected and there was a meltdown and so on.
因为福产那边有核电厂的泄漏等等。
Before our team went up, we were actually advised by the Singapore government not to go.
那时候，新加坡政府给我们忠告是：你们不要去。
Because it's dangerous，
因为很危险。
We cannot guarantee our safety，
不能够保证你的安全。
And they cannot guarantee that anybody, if anything happens, they can bring anyone home。
也不能够保证，如果有事情发生，我们可以带你回来。
So back then, Pastor Kong was the senior pastor。
那时候，宽恕球牧师是主任牧师。
He met with the whole team that volunteered to go。
他看到整个的和整个的志愿团队见面。
He explained the situation。
跟他们解释这个状况。
And he said, if anybody wants to pull out of this team and not go, no questions asked, no problem。
他说：“如果你们有任何人，如果想要撤离，不要去，我们不会有任何的疑问。”
Not a single person pulled out from that team.
没有任何人退出。
One of the volunteers then is now a staff of our church.
其中一位志愿者现在是我们的全职同工。
His name is Daniel Tan. His son was just, I think, maybe about 6 months old, around that, a few months old at that point in time.
是 Daniel Tan， 他那时候他的孩子才几个月大。
He had a lot to lose.
他有很多可以失去的。
But he still went.
但他还是去。
And I talked to some of the first people on the ground there.
那时候我去到那边的去到那边的人的，跟他们一起交谈。
They were telling me that when they got there, they were among the few people rushing towards the disaster site when everybody was going away.
他们说那时候很多人都是想要从那边日本出来，只有他们是几个想要进去的。
And what I want to say, they don't have enough gas to reach where they need to go, you know.
他们并没有足够的油能去到他们的想要去的地方。
But as they're traveling towards the disaster site.
那他们去到他们的目的地的时候
，People stop there and ask them why you're going this way.
然后就问他，你们为什么要去到那边呢
？We said we're from a church in Singapore. We want to go. We want to help. We brought supplies. We want to help.
我们是来自新加坡教会的，我们带了资源，想要帮助你们。
And people started to take their own gas and give to them.
然后有人就把自己的油来给他们家。
Take this, go, keep driving to the disaster site.
拿我们的油，然后你可以继续的开。
In fact, one part they ran out. They ran out of gas or at one part.
然后到一个地方的时候，他们就真的没有油了。
But thankfully, they ran out of gas.On top of a hill,
但是他们是在山顶上没有。
And they were able to roll all the way down to a place that they were able to get gas after that.
然后他们就可以滑下来，去到可以加油的地方。
I mean, what is this? What's the story here?
哇，这里的故事是什么呢
？It is our legacy of being spirit-led.
就是我们被圣灵带领。
The Holy Spirit said, "Go, we go."
但圣灵说你要去，我们就去。
It's our legacy of being obedient.
就是我们遵从。
It's our legacy of being generous.
就是我们的慷慨。
Not yes, on one hand, giving financially.
是的，我们是以金钱的方式。
But on the other hand, sending our people.
但是我们也是以人力的方式。
And that's how our work in Japan started.
就是我们在日本的事工如何开始的。
And so finally, in 2014, we formally start our church in Sendai.
然后2014年我们就开始我们在仙台的教会了。
And this weekend is our 10th anniversary.
这个周末是十周年纪念。
Now, so this way, I need your help.
所以我需要你的帮助。
Pastor Caleb asked me to record a video greeting to them.
Pastor Caleb 叫我们为他们做一个录影。
I was going to record it after service ends, and I just say, you know, just hey, hi, church, whatever kind of thing.
我们聚会结束以后才做这一部分。
But then this morning, I was walking here in TC, the Holy Spirit spoke to me.
但是今天早上圣灵对我说。
Because last night I made this statement to the church.
因为昨天晚上我说这句话。
I said, I am not FCBC.
我说我不是坚信进信教会。
FCBC is all of you.
坚信进教会是你们每一个人。
And if anything, whatOur church in Japan needs to connect with is the larger FCBC family.
就是我们在日本的教会需要连接的是我们的大家庭。
So no point just seeing me in that video.
所以不单只要看到我而已。
Since we're at service this morning.
现在我们在这里了。
I want all of you to be in that video.
我们一起在这个视频里面。
So here's what's going to happen.
我们要做的是。
I'm going to record a video. I'm just going to say a few lines. I'm going to thank God for them and everything.
我们会讲几句话，做一个录影。
I'll speak a word of blessing over them.
会祝福他们。
But then after that, at the end.
之后呢？
I'm going to count to three.
我会数到三。
At the count of three,
数到三的时候
I want all of us here and all of us over there at Suntec.
我们数在这里在新达城的
I want you to as loudly as possible say this.
我要你大声地说
FCBC Japan, God loves you and we love you. Can I?
不需要讲中文的，这个不需要讲
中文，只用英文而已。Okay. Because they don't understand Chinese also. Okay, okay, so it's in English only, okay? Okay? FCBC Japan, God loves you and we love you. 可以吗? Can we try? Okay, I count the three, we try. Okay, here and also at Suntec, just try, okay?
我们试一下.
FCBC Japan, God loves you and we love you. Okay, let's try. One, two, and three.
FCBC Japan, God loves you and we love you.
Okay, great. Okay. So those at TC, when I count to three, right, y'all will look to that camera. I know it's very black there, but it's a camera right there. Y'all look at that direction.
对，我们在出来的这里一个摄影。
Those at Suntec, there's a camera on the platform on the stage in front of y'all. Okay, y'all look to that one.
你的摄像头是在你前面的。
Okay, when y'all do that, right? Okay, y'all can please wave and.
都做的时候也齐心的手，然后向他们招手。
Sound like y'all happy lah. Okay, but yeah, just be excited about it. Okay,
跟他们打招呼。
Okay, so that's what we're gonna do, and then I'll share with you a bit more, then we'll close the service. Hi, FCBC Japan. It is so good to be able to speak to all of you, and I hear that this coming weekend is a special weekend because this weekend marks 10 years of FCBC Sendai. I think 10 years ago, we formally started our church over there in Sendai. It's been 10 years of God's faithfulness, 10 years of His goodness, and we are so excited that the season ahead is going to be even better. So today, I just want to bring you a word of greeting. I want to just bless you with this simple word from Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20, that says that God can do exceedingly abundantly more than we hope or dream or ask of. So I want to encourage all of you to keep believing God for greater things, to ask Him for more things, to dream that God can do something wonderful, not only in our church in Japan, but all throughout the entire nation of Japan. So we're so thankful for all of you. Special shout out to Pastor Caleb, Pastor Christina and Charlotte. We thank God for all of you as well. Thank God for all the hard work you put into supporting the church and the ministry there. But beyond that, I just want all of you to know, we're not just here. I'm not just here with you just by myself, but the rest of FCBC is here and they want to say something very beautiful to all of you, all right? So all of us here ready? One, two, and three.
FCBC Japan,
God loves you and we love you. Praise God. Thank you so much. Thanks for helping. But yeah, I mean, our whole Japan work really is about us being driven by that purpose. You know, we can don't do all this and just say, hey, let's just do our own thing here in Singapore. But beyond that, I want to share with you some other things I've been experiencing as well.
此外要分享一些我们经历的事情。This
year, I haven't been to Japan that much for our with our church.
今年我没有去到 日本那么多次。
Because last year, last year I spent more time with them.
因为去年花很多时间跟他们在一起。
This year I'm spending more time with our church in Timor-Leste.
然后今年花更多时间在东帝汶。
The first time I went to Timor-Leste was last November.
然后第一次去到东帝汶是去年的11月份。
I think this trip is my 6th or 7th time since then.
然后从那时候开始，这一次礼拜二可能是我第六、第七次去到那边了。
I want to share with you why I went to Timor-Leste last November.
我跟你分享为什么我去年11月份要去到东帝汶。
Because there are some aspects of our work that, I mean, we've been in Timor-Leste for a long time.
但我们在东帝汶已经很长时间了。
We're thankful for many missionaries who have gone there.
我们很感恩去到那边的宣教士。
I'm very thankful for Pastor Cat Fu, who's been there for I think over 10 years.
对，是 Pastor Cat Fu 去那边有超过10年了。
But last year, I was asking God this.
然后去年我问神这个问题。
I said, God, I feel like closing down our work in Timor.
我想要关闭掉我们在东帝汶的施工了。
There are different issues we're facing. I said, maybe just time. We've done enough there. Time to close shop and move on.
好像我们那边做的施工够多了，可能是时候要关了。
And God told me one this one thing.
神对我说这一句话。
Don't stop that work without walking the ground first.
但是你没有去到那边，就先不要关。
So I said, okay, I'll do that.
说好，我会去。
So I arranged this trip with our team.
然后我就安排这个团队一起去。
But at the back of my mind, I went there with the plan to close down our work there already.
但是我脑子里想的是，我去到那边是想要怎样关掉。
So on the second or third day of our trip,
然后我们去到那边的第二、第三天。
We were driving to go and to a missionary's house to visit them.
那么我去找一个那边当地的一个宣教士。
And we got lost, and so we stopped at a field nearby.
然后我们就迷路了，我们就在一个空地旁边。
One of our staff went to ask around where's the house.
然后职工去那边问，哎，那个宣教士住在哪里啊
？I got out of the car, started walking around.
然后我下车就开始四处走动。
And I asked God, God, what am I doing here?
我说神，我在这里做什么？
He said, it's hot, I'm sweaty and everything, what am I doing here?
这里又热，我满身大汗。
I said, God, I know you've spoken very clearly about Japan.
我说神，你对很清楚地说关于日本的话。
I said, I just don't feel anything about Timor.
但关于东帝汶，我没什么感受。
And just as I said that,
然后当我这么说的时候，
in this field, I saw a rock with a plaque on it.
然后在这个空地上面，我看到石头上面有一个石碑。
And on that plaque was the Japanese flag and the Timorese flag.
在那石碑上面有日本的国旗，还有东帝汶的国旗。
And I was like, what are the odds in the some random road out there in the countryside? I see a Japanese flag and a Timorese flag side by side.
我说这样的几率是多高呢？就是多小呢？我在一个随机的地方看到这个征兆。
Because one of the roads there was built by the Japanese.
因为其中一条道路是日本人建造的。
And so I saw that.
我看到这点的时候。
And remember, I said to God.
我对神说。
Okay, I understand already.
哇，我理解了，我懂了。
At that moment, I still felt nothing about Timor.
那时候我对东帝汶还没有这样的感受。
It was still just another place to me.
只是对我来说另外一个地方而已。
But I said, God, if this is what you're saying, we will stay here.
那神说，如果这是你对我说的话，我们就会留在那里。
I told the team that day, I said actually that day I can go home already.
我对他团队说，那天我就可以回家了。
I said, I know what God is saying already.
我知道神说说什么了。
I may not feel anything about it.
可能感受还不够强烈。
But God, if you say so, I will be.
但如果神你这么说，我就这么做。
And so since then, we've been increasing our efforts there instead.
从那时候开始，我们一直在加倍的努力，把我们的资源放在那边。
Next year, I hope to bring more of us there.
可能去年、明年会更加带更多人去到那边。
In fact, now this is a tourist attraction.
啊，现在是很多人去那边观光。
Whenever I bring a team, I'll bring them to this place to see. Now,
每次带团队都会去他们那个石碑那边。
In fact, I shared this story at a conference in Timor.
我在东帝汶的一个特会也分享这个故事。
And other Christians from other churches started to go and visit this
plaque. 其他教会的基督徒也去看那个石碑。
But for me, it's very important that I bring our team there.
对我来说，我带我们的团队去那边是很重要。
It's like when the Israelites cross the River Jordan.
就像以色列人去到过约旦河的时候。
And God said, put the memorial stone so that generations will remember.
神说你要立一个纪念碑，然后世代都可以纪念。
Every time I see that, it's a reminder of our purpose.
每次我看到这个石碑，就是神提起我们在那边的旨意。
That God's purpose for this church is more than just ourselves.
就神对我们教会的旨意，不单是我们自己而已。
And so this is how we are seeing. Like I said, our church is on the way.
我们教会正在前进的路上。
We're quite on the way to being that community that is purpose driven.
成为一个使命的教会。
But the final thing I want to share.
最后我要分享的是。
Is how I'm seeing that.It's not just as a church as a whole.
不但是我们教会一整个整体。
But individually, we are becoming purpose-driven.
而是我们个人也成为一个使命的
信徒。And I'm so happy I'm seeing individuals, people of our church who are being spirit-led, who are being obedient, who are being generous.
看到我们教会的个人也是被圣灵引导，也是尊崇跟慷慨。
And today, I want to honor one couple who has exemplified this.
今天我要尊荣一对夫妇，他们有这样的榜样。
And with this,I also want to make an announcement.
当我这个分享的时候，也做一个报告。
The cell leaders are aware of this because I informed them early on.
他们的小组组长之前已经知道了。
But I want to use this weekend to speak to the whole church about this.
但是利用这个周末跟整个教会来分享。
Today I want to talk about Pastors Ching Kuang and Siu Chin.
今天我讲的是 Pastor Ching Kuang 跟 Siu Chin.
They were here with us last night. They're here this morning as well.
他们昨晚也在，今天早上也在。
I want to announce that.Pastors Ching Kuang and Siu Chin will be stepping out of the Senior Pastors 12. They will no longer be team pastors moving ahead.
我要分享的是，郑冠和秀琴牧师他们会不再做团队牧师。
And I want to take this opportunity to explain a little bit why.
然后花这个机会来解释为什么。
Now, in our church, this is how we've always been structured.
在我们教会里面，我们的结构是这样。
As part of the G12 vision, we have 12 teams, each headed by a married couple.
我们是G12意向的教会，然后有12个团队，每个团队有一对夫妇。
But thus far, all our married couples, either one of them is a full-time staff of the church.
但是我们的团队的牧师有一个是全职同工。
When Pastor Ching Kuang and Siu Chin were called to come and serve in the Senior Pastors 12,
当郑冠秀琴牧师他们被呼召成为我们十二的时候，
we wanted to try something new.
我们想要尝试一些新的东西。
Where we want wanted to put lay people in this position of leadership.
就放在不是全职同工的，放在这个领袖的位置。
And so when we're looking around,
我们四处看的时候
，their names came up.
他们的名字被呈上来。
And we spoke to them, they were challenged.
我们对他们说话，他们被挑战。
And they came on board, and they've been serving.
他们愿意过来一起服侍。
They were installed as team pastors in 2018.
他们在2018年被高立成为团队牧师。
So that's been 6 years.
已经有六年了。
Well, as they journey along.
他们和我们一起同行的时候
they gave it all that they had.
他们给他们的全部。
But along the way, certain difficulties started to surface.
当然他们也遇到一些困难。
One thing we realized that there was a reason why we always had one in the couple as a full-time staff.
其实我们有一个团队牧师，连其中一位是全职同工是有原因的。
Because the amount of support a team needs is a lot.
有一个团队需要的扶持是很多的。
From regular counseling,
说一般的辅导
hospital visits, emergencies, funerals, baby dedication, so on.
哦，亲生儿，然后还有丧礼之类的。
There are a lot of things there that the pastor has to look after.
是有很多需要一个牧者来照顾的。
And they have to look into all this also.
他们也需要做这些事情。
But it was a struggle.
但对他们来说是这很困难。
And so they came to speak to me about it.
所以他们对我来说，
And the thing is, they never came to complain about that.
他们来不是抱怨。
But one thing that was always on their heart is this.
他们在心里面一直有的一个态度就是。
Their concern was that they are shortchanging the team.
他们觉得他们亏欠了他们的团队。
They can't give all the attention and time that's needed.
他们觉得力不从心。
And that was what was eating them up for a very long time.
所以让他们觉得很痛苦。
And we spoke for, I think, up to 2 years about this and on and off about it.
我们可能谈了这点谈了两年。
And...Every time they raise it, I say, just hang in there, hang in there.
每次他们这么说的时候，我说你再坚持一会，再坚持一会。
And every time I say hang in there, they really hang in there.
每次我说坚持一会的话，他们回去就真的再坚持。
But we took the time really to talk through it and to seek the Lord on this.
那我们花时间来沟通，来寻求神。
And finally, I felt myself and Serene, we felt that comfort and that confidence to release them.
最后我和袁牧师有这样的平安来释放他们。
And so that's why we are making this announcement.
所以我们做这样一个报告。
And them being released is not because they are doing a bad job.
他们被离开做不做团的牧师，不是因为他们做一些差的工作。
And it's not because they have failed.
不是他们失败。
If anything, I would say our church has failed.
如果是有什么的话，是我们教会的一个失败。
Now, is it possible for lay people to lead at that level of leadership in the church?
有没有可能一般的信徒做团队牧师呢？
Absolutely.
当然可以。
But there needs to be systems of support.Processes of how they can be empowered and equipped to perform that role.
而是教会必须要有一个体系，这个架构来支持他们。
And unfortunately, what we've learned is that we are not at that place yet.
但不幸的是，我们教会还没有这样的一个体系。
So I believe one day we're going to have lay people serving at the highest level of leadership in the church.
但我们相信有一天，我们教会也有一般的信徒来做这样的领袖。
But as senior pastor, there are some things I need to work on first.
但是作为主任牧师，有些事情我要先做。
To ensure that we set people up.To be the best that they can be.
来确保以后的团队牧师能够做得好。
So with that, this weekend we're going to take some time to pray for Pastor Jing Kuan and Xiu Jun.
所以这个周末我们会为正光和修行牧师祷告。
But I want to say this to the entire church.
我对整个教会说。
I think they demonstrate what it means to be spirit led, to be obedient, and to be generous.
因为他们是我们圣灵引导、尊崇、慷慨的一个榜样。
When the church are trying this out, they just follow and say, if they just obey and say, if this is what the Lord says, let's do it.
当教会这么说的时候，他们说如果是圣灵引导，教会引导，我们就会跟随。
And they were generous with their very own lives.
他们对自己的人生时间也非常的慷慨。
Last night I was just talking about Pastor Jing Kuan.
昨天晚上我才跟正光牧师说。
Other than serving in this capacity as a leader, as a team pastor.
不但是作为团队牧师来服侍。
You know, he also served on the TCS board, on the Gateway Arts board, on the Touch International board at one point or so.
他也是出来社会服务，然后教委艺术的董事会。
And the thing is not just a him thing, you know.
不但是他个人。
Pastor Xiu Jun has to be generous with her husband.
就是牧师也要愿意释放他的丈夫。
The children have to be generous with their father, their mother.
他们孩子要慷慨，能够愿意释放他们的爸爸。
And I think that's a very beautiful thing.
这是一个很美妙的事情。
And so today I really want to pray over them and appreciate the two of them.
所以今天我要为他们祷告，来感恩，感谢他们的生命。
I know there are some questions with this move.
但可能会有一些提问。
Now, what's going to happen to them?
然后他们会发生什么呢？
They are still in our church.
他们还在我们教会。
Pastor Jing Kuan and Xiu Jun will move to our 144. They will serve under as the 12th of Pastor Wee Long and Christabel.
他们会在 Pastor Wee Long 跟静怡牧师的12。
One part of their team will move under Pastor Willem Christabel's team.
然后他们团队的一部分去到韦伦牧师的经营牧师的团队。
The other part will move to Pastor Eugene and Dorothy's team.
另外一个部分是到那个 Pastor 国贤牧师还有 Pastor Dorothy 以下。
So now the million dollar question is, so who's going to be new team pastors?
那现在问题是谁会是新的团队牧师呢？
Well, with this announcement, I just want to let you know.
然后我要让你知道的是，
there's no new team pastor.
没有新的团队牧师。
Not for this, not for now.
啊，现在还没有。
But people say, "Wow, pastor like that, how can?"
啊，牧师，那怎么可以这样？
We are G12 church, you know.
我们 G12 教会。
Now 11 teams only.
哇，才有十一个团队。
You say we're not serious about the G12 vision.
是不是G12的意向不够认真？
Actually, it's the opposite.
当然不是。
It's because we're very serious about the G12 vision.
反而是因为我们认真对待 G12 的意向。
I don't want to just anyhow.Approach this.
我们不想要随随便便放一个人上去。
I mean, Serena and I already started the process of looking for people, identifying different ones.
我们已经开始这个寻找这个新的团队牧师了。
I want to make sure that we install team pastors, we prepare them, we set them up to do their best in that area.
但是我们要确保有新的团队牧师能够做得好，能够确保他们能够成功。
So we're taking the next 1 year to really work on this.
那我们接下来一年来做这件事情。
So we're not going to function like that for the next 10 years or whatever. No.
但不是要花10年的时间来做这件事。
It's something we're working actively on.
是我们积极会做的。
But at this point, I really want to pray for the two of them.
现在我们要为他们祷告。
So can I invite Pastor Jingguan Siuqi? Can you stand?
好，正
关系。Can we just put our hands together and just thank God for their lives and really appreciate them?
为他们生命献上感恩。
Today they put tissue on my pulpit for me.
今天他们放的纸巾。
Because last night I cried during this part.
昨天哭得很惨。
I was very emotional at this point.
我有很多的触动。
I mean, it's not just because of Jingguan and Siuqi or what.
但不单是因为他们个人。
But because I was just very overwhelmed by this church.
而是我为我们教会所做的很感动。
I mean, I share a lot about Pastor Jingguan and Siuqi.
我分享很多关于他们的。
But they are two of many people in this community who are spirit-led, obedient, and generous.
但是他们只是其中两位，我们还有很多人都是被圣灵带导、引导，这样尊崇、这样慷慨的。
You know, sometimes it's quite crazy how God has blessed this church.
有时候我们想到神如何祝福我们教会，我们真的是感到很惊叹。
There are many things that we do, I can't even understand how it's even possible.
我们做了很多事情，我都想不通为什么可能呢？
Of course, it's possible because of the power of God.
但是因为神的大能才能够可能。
But it's possible because of faithful men and women in this church.
但是因为我们教会里面有很多像你们这样的坚信的仆人。
Men and women like Jingguan and Siuqin.
像他们这样的仆人
，Men and women like any of you seated here or over there at Sunday，
像很多在座的各位
，And that's why I'm just very appreciative。
所以我非常的感恩。
Why don't we stretch our hands towards them wherever you are？
好好向上伸手。
Stretch our hands forward。
在这里，在新大城也是一样。
Lord, we thank you for the lives of Pastors Jingguan and Siuqin。
所以我们感恩正光和秀行牧师的生命。
Lord, while they may no longer be in this office of a pastor，
虽然他不再是做团队牧师
，But more important than that is that they are your faithful son and daughter。
但更重要的是，他们是你忠心的儿女。
Lord, we commit them in this next season to your hands。
我们把他们的下一个季节交托给你。
Lord, whatever has transpired in the last 6 years，
无论过去6年发生了什么
，We know it's not gone to waste。
我们知道不是突然的
，Because you have been working throughout every single year。
因为每一年都有你的工作。
May you continue to bless them。
让你继续的祝福他们。
May you continue to use them。
继续的使用他们。
And their entire family as well。Lord, as they have honored you with their lives,
让他们以人生来尊崇你。
Lord, please honor them.
你也尊崇他们。
And bless them.
来祝福他们。
Just as your word has said, Lord.
就像你总是说的。
Those who have been generous towards others.
那些慷慨待人的。
They themselves will be refreshed.
他们自己也会得到滋润。
So Pastor Jingguan Siuqi, I speak that refreshment will come upon you.
所以正光秀贤牧师说你会得到滋润。
And I declare fresh life into your family and your children as well.
我宣告你的家庭的生命会有一个全新的开始。
And that there will be a new season ahead for all of you.
会有一个新的季节。
So Lord, bless them.
所以主啊祝福他们。
And watch over them.
来看顾他们。
In your powerful name we pray.
奉你的大名祷告。
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Come and thank the Lord for them.
Hallelujah. 感谢主，感谢主。请坐。
We're going to close off this service right now.
我现在要结束我们聚会。
Sorry, I took a bit longer, but it's really 家事了 really family.
真的是一个很好的家庭的时间。
And I said I'm going to do it this week because I'm gone for the next 2 weeks or so in Timor.
因为接下来两周我会去到东帝汶了。
But I'm just saying that there's a lot of things coming up for us as a church.
我们教会有很多事情在发生。
God wants us to do so much more.
神想要做更多的事情。
And it's not for us to feel, wow, sian, so many things to do.
我们说哦，我们还有这么多的事情要做，感到很累。
But it's a It's a divine privilege that God has for us.
是个神圣的一个荣幸。
I invite all of us to stand.
好，我们一起站起来。
But today, as we close this service, I want to pray that this will be what all of us hold on to as a church.
今天我们祷告的时候，我们教会会紧抓住这一点。
That all of us will learn what it means to be spirit-led.
我们会懂得什么是被圣灵引导。
That all of us will learn what it means to be obedient.
懂得什么是存心遵从。
And all of us will learn what it means to be generous.
懂得什么是慷慨解囊。
So why don't we lift up our hands here and over at Suntec? Let me pray for all of us.
我们在新大城也是一样。
Lord, we thank you so much for today.
主，我们感谢今天的时间。
Continue to build us up as a church.
继续的建造我们教会。
We want to be a purpose-driven church.
我们想要成为一个使命的教会。
Driven by that purpose you have given to all of us.
是你给我们的旨意来驱动我们。
I bless every person here.
我祝福这里的每一个人。
The Lord, we will be led by your spirit and not by our own desires.
我们让你的圣灵带领，而不是我们自己的欲望带领。
Lord, may we always be obedient.
我们永远的遵从你。
And may we be generous.
我们要慷慨。
With our finances, but with our very lives itself.
与我们的金钱，我们的人生慷慨对你。
And Lord, I thank you for this family. For all these faithful men, women, children, youth, and elderly people here.
这所有的每一位年长的、年幼的、年轻的。
Lord, use us.
主啊，使用我们。
And continue to bless us and use us as a blessing to others.
继续的使用我们，成为别人的祝福。
And Lord, I pray that as we go into this final special collection for the year.
主啊，当我们做最后的今年的这个特殊的筹款。
Lord, use us.
使用我们。
Teach us what it means to sow in a generous way.
教导我们如何慷慨地播种。
Lord, we pray for all the upcoming missions efforts we have.
我们为来临的各样的宣教事工祷告。
Lord, today I want to pray for celebration of life.
今天我们为幸福人生祷告。
As we run the evangelistic program in the next month.
当我们在下个月做这个幸福人生演出的时候。
Lord, many people in Japan will come to the shows. They will hear the gospel, and the seed of the gospel will be planted deeply in their hearts.
在日本的众人，他们会参加这个演出。福音的种子会播在他们的生命里面。
We pray for Pastor Kong, Pastor Nina who are here.
我们为匡牧师、陆业牧师祷告。
Anoint them as they prepare for the show and the evangelistic effort.
恩膏他们，他们在预备这演出的时候。
Lord bless Pastor Kong as he preaches to the people at the shows.
祝福匡牧师当他对众人讲福音的时候。
And Lord, we can't even say we fully understand what is going on and what we have to do.
我们不能够完全了解将要发生的事。
But we want to follow your spirit.
但我们要跟随你的圣灵。
We want to obey.
我们想要遵从。
We want to be generous with our very lives.
我们要以我们的生命慷慨奉献。
And Lord, as we sow into Japan.
但我们在日本播种。
Do something that only you can do.
做你只有你能够做的。
Lord, just as there was revival in Antioch.
就像在安提阿有复兴。
Let there be revival in Japan as well.
在日本也有复兴。
Let there be revival in Timor Leste.
在东帝汶也复兴。
Let there be revival in all the different nations that we're working together with.
在万国都有复兴。
And all the different countries that our churches are in.
在我们教会在不同的万国里面。
Lord, come and use us as a church.
使用我们做一个教会。
May we truly be that faith community that you've called us to be.
让我们真正成为坚信的群体。
So we surrender our lives.
我们献上我们的生命。
Use us.
使用我们。
In your mighty name we pray.
奉你的大名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's give God all the glory.
Hallelujah. 荣耀归主。
God bless you. You are dismissed.
神祝福你。我们散会了。
Have a great week ahead.
有个美好的周末。
I'll see you when I'm back from Timor.
然后从中地回来再和大家见面。